Kind day to you all. I'm Kinsmark.
And I'm Violeta.
Chilling in some Soul Calibur 5, because I'm in the mood to just have a calm evening cutting some fools up. Because as I told her earlier, the plan was to start the next game in a certain series. However...
Series?
Yeah, I was hoping you wouldn't catch that.
Too bad.
As I told her, I am not in the mood to get mad today, and I have a feeling...
We're not sure if we would or not, yeah, but we don't want to roll those dice.
Yeah, I'm in the mood to stay in a good mood, because I actually am, because this is the first day in almost 3 weeks that I haven't awoken in pain. I can actually move around. Like, I, at this point, can just feel some tension around the abdominal area. I can actually get in and out of a car normally. I can sit normally. I'm still gonna give it a few days before I actually just, like, sit at my desk and crunch out editing for hours and hours and hours at a time. However, I was able to do some editing yesterday. I did some scripting the day prior, and I can actually sit on the couch today comfortably instead of, like, craned and reclined away from everything really strangely and awkwardly. So
in other words, he's super excited and doesn't want to ruin that with potential frustration at games.
Yeah! Yeah, exactly that! Yeah. So, I'm gonna play a game that I like.
Yep.
And, that's, how the evening's gonna go.
Yep,
so.
Ghost is here and says, hey, y'all!
Hey, cheers, matey!
And, Sheil is here and says, hiya. Ghost says,
Eh?
...
Are you, a little concerned about the camera that is missing? Because we're still capturing from the couch, and therefore...
No, I think he's saying something about, maybe two? About the game? I don't know.
Because, yeah, we still haven't set up a, camera.
Oh, Ghost says, no, just the story of this one. Because we said we actually like this game. We like the gameplay of this game. Nobody plays this game for the story.
Clarification on that note, yeah, because that is a poignant note. The story of this game, what story there is atrocious.
Because it's not finished.
Yeah, it isn't finished. It's clearly just comprised
They're using
of,
storyboards.
Yeah, actual sketchy storyboards.
Not to mention they missed some of the storyboards, clearly. Stuff happens that you never see.
They skip scenes accidentally. And it centers around a couple of new characters that nobody cares about. Patroclus and... his sister, whose name I definitely remember because she's so memorable. Anyway.
I feel bad because I used to know this.
Hang on. Oh, fine. Quick.
Hey, yeah, titles.
I'm just gonna,
what
was her name again?
I don't know.
Because this should tell
I'm
you
upset.
Something. Yeah, stage of history and all that. Where is
Pyrrha.
She?
There
we go. Yeah, Pyrrha. There we go.
I kept trying to, you know what I kept trying to say?
Like, Fina?
I kept trying to say Fina or Pharah, my character.
Yeah.
It's Pyrrha. So it's somewhere in between.
Yeah.
You know?
So, the character creation is 100%. My favorite part of this game, and the actual like combat and everything, the controls are sharp.
Yeah, so it's fun to play.
Yeah,
if you're good at this kind of game, which I am not.
Yeah, I still enjoy playing this. It's just for the customized arcade run experience because I already long since completed everything in Legendary Souls. I got my ass handed to me and checked my ego on online multiplayer. So at this point, I pretty much just do. You know, custom characters through arcade mode and just have fun doing that. And I'm content with that.
Sheil says, I made it through today of giving mom her meds. Only mishap was with the IV pole. Oldest had to set it up for us. It was way... it was so stressful.
Yeah, I mean, kind wishes to all of you and yours, because that situation is intense.
That's rough.
Yeah, like I told you on Discord, make sure you are getting the rest that you need, because if you have to stay that closely on top of all that stuff,
it can be really hard.
Yeah,
and like, you need to get your rest.
Oh yeah, because I mean, if you don't, that could cause problems for her if you like miss something. So like, take care of yourself first, because if you aren't taken care of, you may not have the ability to take care of the family. So yeah, that's my input there. I'm just trying to look out for you and yours. So anyway, let's see here. I'll jump into the creation real quick. Because as anyone that's caught any streams that we have done of this in the past, because we have
made. And you know what? Number 10, I still don't know who she is, but I want to make her super bad.
Yeah. About half of these are tabletop characters that we've made for different settings over the years, and the other half of these are replicas of characters from anime games and such. So,
And there's a handful of other. I think that one's King Addie's.
Yeah, and all of these are the Iconics from Pathfinder, except for Kilvanir, because he's one of my Pathfinder characters. This guy, I think, was Ghosts, because he came to visit.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Yep.
Man, I haven't got any, like, slots.
Yes,
free.
We do.
Do we?
At the very, very top, the second down. There we go.
Oh, yeah. A couple here.
Can we make maybe some of our current stuff that we're working on?
The one thing I was going to do is edit Ciri's hair real quick.
Oh, because her hair is no longer proper? Because
we decided that she was going to have the dark hair with the single white streak instead of the all white.
Oh, yeah.
So, real quick.
Let's see. Sky says, oh, yeah, LLP streams today. Hey!
Heck yes.
And Ghost says, I forgot about him. I miss him. Smiley face.
You gotta come visit so you can play him again.
Too bad we can't give her the white streak.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, maybe. Could. Is there a feather accessory? Or
yeah,
do we have any
accessories? It wouldn't move with the hair physics, though.
That's true.
So it wouldn't look right.
Yeah.
All right, there we go. Finish edit. Astral Home. So I'll just jump into an arcade run real quick because I want to knock the rust off of my recollection of the controls. So, arcade.
Ghost says, as soon as I possibly can.
Always welcome, my man. Alright, let's see. You know what? I'll just, I'll do a Ciri run. Ciri,
yay!
Where are you? Says, hey.
She's at the front, you know.
There she is.
And yes, this is, one of my Pathfinder characters. Who was about as self-sufficient as I could make her.
Yeah. Actually wasn't meant to copy the name of Ciri from the Witcher series. It just sort of ended up that way.
That name is actually a real world name.
It is. It's actually common in some parts of the world.
And it's not short for anything. It's just that is just her full name is Ciri. Cause he's hard of hearing, clearly.
I don't get what they were going for with Vi. Oh, also, celebrations are in order, speaking of the Witcher. Because they have announced now a Soul Calibur 6 is in the works. And Geralt the Rivia. Oh, yeah. Geralt the Rivia, the White Wolf, is confirmed as one of, at least, the guest characters for that game.
Yep.
And
I really wish Noctis would be.
Well, they'd put him in Tekken.
I know, but I feel like he fits better in.
Yeah.
The sword part, anyway.
Well, yeah, I mean, Yoshimitsu's in Tekken.
And I always felt he felt weird in Tekken, though.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, it works.
Like, they've put weapon users in Tekken earlier.
And he goes, woohoo, about damn time!
Yeah, man.
I know, right? Shield says, on the tournament front, I am down to the final two lifts and the ending requirement to go. Just waiting for them to age up.
Hey, good time.
Awesome! You're almost there!
Can you actually lower the volume on the TV?
Oh, yeah,
it's
I forgot. This is... That's because we had it set on 9.
Yeah, that was for our YouTube viewing.
Yeah, we were...
Oh, I perfected it. I wasn't even trying.
Whoops.
Mitsurugi is my strongest form in this game, so I can actually do that without any effort. Anyway.
Yeah. Shield says, unless something majorly goes wrong, then this will be the first time ever that I've made it through a tournament with only one restart.
Hey, good time.
Wow, that's impressive.
Congrats. Yeah, I can't say for certain, because I haven't checked in any depth at all yet. Comments maybe some of you guys will know. I think that the next Soul Calibur is actually
a prequel, or maybe a
rehash of one of the classic Soul Calibur games. Because Sophia's in it again, a young Mitsurugi
is in
it.
I'm pretty sure Cassandra's in it again.
I haven't actually seen Cassandra.
No?
Because she's a little younger than Sophia.
Yeah.
So, I can't really... I think I saw Killik in it.
Zhonghua, was she in it?
Yes, Zhonghua's in it, which I far prefer over her replacement from this game.
Yeah, that will make Miss T happy, because Zhonghua was her go-to.
She mained Zhonghua. So, Yeah, any insight that you guys can confirm one way or another, I am certainly...
I think it's probably either a prequel or it's going to be essentially, like, I guess, the Mortal Kombat that we have.
Yeah, where it's like a reboot.
Yeah, it's like a reboot, but not.
Yeah.
Or,
I mean, who knows? Maybe they're doing, like, Chronomancy shenanigans or something.
They could.
Oh, time warp.
They could. I mean, there's clearly a lot of weird magical shenanigans. I mean, look at behind freaking, test tubes and stuff, so.
Alchemical creepy creatures. And, like, Soul Calibur is the setting of Handwavium magic.
Yeah.
It's like, soul swords and magic. Just take our word for it. Just go with it.
Guess says, ooh, good combo and concept there. Shiel says, then I'm gonna do it all over again. Vlogging that one. I wouldn't have had the one restart if it wasn't for the game files getting glitched on the having baby.
Ah.
Oh. So it says, so who's going to see Infinity War? I am. And Ghost says, should be going to see it on Friday, hopefully.
Hey, good times. Let me know vaguely how it is.
Yeah.
Because we're going to give
we
it a few
are
weeks.
Going to see, we are going to see it. We're just not seeing it right away because we don't want to deal with the rush of people.
Yeah, because we live in the city and every theater around here is just going to turn into a madhouse for Infinity War. So we're going to wait until the crowds die down.
Yeah, and our family prefers going to a specific theater with specific seats.
Yeah.
And those seats are going to be hard to come by right now because I'm sure they're already booked full.
Yeah, I'm sure those are all reserved.
Let's see. Shield says, also, I'm not rushing and just finishing it with 1 minute left to go. You know?
That's not rushing. That's making the most possible use
out of your
every
time.
Minute.
Yeah. Making your time count.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, so no spoilers on Infinity War. Just let us know in vague terms if it's good, bad,
middling. Yeah, like I saw
middling.
Jack mention on Twitter that it was, like, amazingly good. Again, he is one of those that is sometimes easy to please, so, you know, like, we all have those friends and people that we know where if they say a movie's good, it's like, okay,
it might be.
You have no standards, though. That's not necessarily what I'm saying of Jack, it's just that, you know, I've heard some other folks that got early screenings, like, you know, common YouTube celebs and stuff like that, they're all just like, it's the super greatest, and I'm like, yeah, except you enjoyed Game X that was awful because it was pretty, so
yeah, or or you were really nice about Game Y because they put effort into it even though it was bad.
Exactly. So there's some folks that I'm just like, just because you're excited about it
doesn't mean that we'll like it.
Yeah.
That's not to say it's not good, it just might not be our taste.
And I don't mean to come across like elitist or anything, it's just like I am kind of picky about movies, so
yeah. So it says, I am a bit mad at Marvel, though. They moved up the release date here by a day to fall on Anzac Day? A-N-Z-A-C Day.
I've heard the term. I don't know what that holiday's for, though.
Says, kind of insensitive there. So Scarlet.
Isn't that one of the, like, military holidays or something?
Yeah.
I don't quite remember. Ow.
And I'm betting they did it because if it's a holiday, they expect more people could go see it.
Yeah. Because would that put it also on a start of the weekend release for you? Because that would also affect that, I would think.
Yeah, because they do tend to try and put things on either holidays where people have off to capitalize on people having, for a lot of people being off to go see it, or on starts of weeks, or at the end of the week. One of those two tends to be.
Owie.
Shiel says, I'm also having fun with Minecraft.
It's a good time.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a really good just
it's one of those it's
zen sort of game.
It's what you make it.
Yeah.
And if you want to just have a calm time, you can do that. If you want to have like go hunting and probably die many times, you can do that.
I still haven't mastered the new combat system since that update.
I've stopped playing it because I'm not good at it.
I've hardly played it at all since the combat update. Because they added in, like, shields and all kinds of stuff.
Yeah, and, like, I realized that I was like, like, because I kept spamming the attack button because that's what I used to do, but
you can't do that
anymore.
You gotta time it.
And I'm just, like, that is my habit, and I can't break it.
Oh, God, no!
So it says, that day is a commemoration of all of our military service since World War I, and it was a Wednesday.
So it's kind of like Veterans Day for you guys.
Yeah. Gotcha. So yeah, I could. Yeah, it's a bit insensitive.
Yeah, a little.
But if it is a day a lot of people have off, yeah, then that makes sense from a commercial standpoint.
Financial advantage.
Yeah.
Jesus, man, give me a second here, man. Dang.
And I mean, they've done stuff like that for like Veterans Day, Memorial Day here all the time.
That's just an expected thing.
Yeah, if a release would have been close to that date, yeah, they usually move it till it's on that date.
Oh yeah.
Oh, Yoshimitsu the second?
Yeah.
Who's the first?
I think it's actually. No, it's not the one from. Forget which game it was that this Yoshimitsu replaced the one from like the old Soul Calibur.
And then is Yoshimitsu from Tekken the third? Or is he still the second?
He's probably even older than that. Or rather, like a higher number than that. I don't know for certain though. Because I'm a little rusty on my
Yoshimitsu lore.
My Namco lore. Because Tekken and Soul Calibur do share a world.
Yep.
And apparently,
does that mean
so,
the double genes in this too?
Yep. Which is why double genes form is available in this game, and this also apparently crosses over to the Street Fighter universe because the latest—I don't know if it's the latest,
are
one of the
is
Tekken,
it full connected universes?
Oh yeah, like that's just a theory. And at this point, it's confirmed because. I think it was Ryu was in the new Tekken, and I think so was, I can't remember his name because I'm not a huge Street Fighter guy, the red-haired, like, demon guy, I can't remember his name, one of the antagonists from the Street Fighter series. And I think they also implied in that Tekken game that the, corruption from like demonic energy that Ryu has is essentially the same thing as the devil gene from Jin and his family.
So it's a thing that more than one family has.
Apparently, I don't know. Like I haven't played.
Or I guess maybe he's like an offshoot of this family that just nobody knew.
Maybe either that, or maybe like devil crafted another deal with some other family or something. I don't know because I haven't played through the latest Tekken.
Yeah,
I haven't actually played the last couple of Tekken.
I want it, though.
Oh, so do I. It's just,
for one specific reason.
I know you want the latest one because Noctis is in it.
Yes, I do. I want any game that has Noctis in it, except for A New Empire, which recently updated and is still just as terrible as ever.
New Empire is just a freaking sham.
Well, that's what it is. It's literally a money sink.
Oh, yeah.
And apparently their servers are terrible.
Oh, yeah.
And they're still bad, even with the update that happened like 2 days ago. It's still bad. And
it's
I'm like
that company.
I know. I keep wanting it to somehow become good at some point, but it's never going.
It will never be good.
I know, but it makes me sad, okay?
I would say that ship has sailed, except it never left dry dock.
I know, but it's 15.
It's
and that
a
makes
cheap
me sad.
Knockoff of 15.
I know it is, and I really wish that their ad minigames were
yeah,
the
was
actual
the way
game.
The actual game played.
Because I like their tower defense minigame.
How sad is it when the ad for your game
is
more
than
fun
the real game?
Than the game? Jesus.
Like, womp! Like, I would play FF15 tower defense. Citadel defense, I guess. Spoilers, it doesn't go well. I mean,
I keep misjudging the range on that, just like a hair too short. See ya. Have a good one.
I just want it to be good. I just really bad. And Sky goes, get whumped, son! Yup. You were just too weak. But yeah, it's makes me sad, because I really, everything that has FF15 on it, I want to be good. And it's not.
Yeah.
It's very much not.
Yeah, I'm still gonna finish the stream of that campaign.
Yeah, Because I want to know what...
I know the last few chapters are
going to be really different.
The most different, yeah.
And I really want to see what Armiger mode is like. And I want to know about the statues.
Yeah. I just haven't had the capacity to sit long enough to play. Yeah, I know. Jesus, Nightmare, give me a second.
And because we've gotten to the we're going to go and storm another base section, and I'm just not good enough at the combat yet, I don't think, to really pull that one off.
Ow.
Otherwise, I'd have played it.
No. Ah.
Good. Because he is cheap.
Oh, yeah. They've even slowed him down. Yeah. He's still cheap.
He was cheaper, but he's still cheap. But yeah, like, I'm still really sad. I am glad that King's Knight turned out to actually be a pretty good game.
Yeah, it's decent. I still prefer Record Keeper and Exvius. It's still decent, though.
Well, I mean, it's Exvius.
Yeah, Exvius is...
my jam.
Way stronger a game than it has any right to be. It's so good, though.
Even the story!
Yeah!
There were times where I turned to... I'm like, who gave you permission to make me upset? And tear up on, like...
Who gave you the right to make me deal with such feels, game?
Well, because I was like, oh, it's like, it's sort of like a pretty pixel art...
Whoa.
FF Pokemon-esque, you know, that happens to have a story mode, right? Like, that's how I imagined it to be when I started it. And then I did the story mode, and I'm like, when did I start caring about these characters? What happened? No, don't... I'm so scared for you. Please be okay.
I was so mad on April Fool's Day because
they teased
a CG full quality, like console level production value version of Exvius.
Complete with voice acting and like, combat, and it was beautiful and I wanted it so bad.
Check out the trailer that they released that was apparently a false trailer.
It was.
The CGI quality is expensive. Yeah, because they spent some money on that. Like, they had to have planned that at least the start of the year. And I have a theory, so many other commenters.
It's just a theory.
That I think they were testing the waters of the response to that trailer. Because if a lot of people got excited, I think they might actually do it.
I would play it.
I think they were actually... 100%.
You know what? I would spend $60 on that.
Hell yeah. Like, if it was actually the full thing, like, all the game... with clearly like some cleaned up mechanics for like how the visions and everything work to make it more of like a single player sort of experience, and just like amped up and prettified, and of course with more of the story than is currently in the mobile version, because it isn't,
they're
totally
not
finished yet.
They're, you know, they're continually releasing more stuff.
Like, if it were a finished version of what the mobile game is, just
Final Fantasy Exvius
with more
Brave
stuff,
Exvius, excuse me,
then I would love that.
I would 100%.
Square when?
PS4 $60 game. Yeah. Would buy 100%. Shut up and take my money.
Like, honestly, I know you are going to disagree with this. However, for me personally, I actually think I might like Exvius even more than FF15.
I'm gonna hit you.
I mean, as that for I'm me personally.
I'm gonna hit you. We don't know how the story ends, though.
We don't. At this point, I don't care, though, because I'm enjoying this journey more than I enjoyed the journey of 15.
I'm gonna hit you. I'm gonna hit you so hard.
I enjoyed the start of 15 and the end of 15. The middle was a slog, and I will not apologize for saying so. Exvius just keeps improving with every chapter.
So far,
yes. We are each, like, 100-plus hours into this game, though.
I know.
So... I'm just saying. She is staring daggers at me right now.
I'm gonna hit you.
I didn't say it was a superior game. I just said I enjoy it more. I am entitled to my preference.
Mm-hmm. Kelps Knight is lurking.
You are most welcome to do so, sir.
Ghost says, what are we talking about? I had to walk away. I told him.
Oh, yeah.
That's why I mentioned the full name.
Oh, okay.
Gus says, yep, 15 was a slog. Sorry, bye. It's okay. The middle was a slog. I just liked the characters and the dialogue enough that I didn't care. I just wish I was better at the combat so that I could do all the sloggy parts instead of Ken, because I wouldn't mind doing the sloggy parts. I'm just not as good at combat as he is.
What level was that crazy mech that I took on as like a level 30?
It was 70.
It was like a 75.
It was like, no, I think it was 73.
Oh, was it? Okay.
Yeah, and I was off camera because I was just doing side quests and leveling some before we continued on with the story. So I was basically doing the not important bits.
Yeah.
And then a dropship came, dropped a level 70-something mech, and I'm like, Uh-oh.
I'm like, hand me the controller. I can take it.
And then
it took
he did.
Me like 15 minutes. I won, though.
Yep. Ghost is true. I do agree about the characters. I never finished the game, though, because of the slog.
It's worth finishing. I'll give you the fair warning, and I'm going to put this in my full review that is indeed still coming. It's just still a work in progress because it's going to end up long. The middle of that game is the worst part of it.
Yeah.
I would say chapters like 7 through 10 are atrocious.
And Zygnotis Keep is hard.
Oh, Zygnotis Keep is just abysmal.
Which is why I'll do it.
Yeah. Like, it's just such a slowdown that grinds the climax of the game to a really unneeded halt.
Yeah. But other than that, the end of the game is like... And I expect it's even better now in... Royal Edition.
I hope so. That's one of the things I'm going to get most critical of. Yeah, like, the ending of that game, the way that I'm going to put it is, it starts out kind of middle of the road, it takes a real steep dip in the middle, and then it climbs to really unexpected heights at the end. Like, it comes together really strongly. So I would say it is worth getting through this log just to get to the end.
Yeah. And because I'm always a sucker for good story and characters, even if the mechanics aren't, you know, like the act of playing it, I am a sucker for that, so I can appreciate it even with the slogginess. And the mechanics of 15 aren't bad.
No.
So, because the mechanics aren't bad...
And one thing that I did notice, I'm going to have to amend part of my review, actually. When we started playing Royal on PC, I don't know if it's where the change came from, or if some patch leading up to it did it. That thing that I said that I really wanted them to do, of changing the attack and the dodge inputs from just a hold down
to
the ability to actually tap, you still can't time things out very well. If you do tap in rapid succession, though...
It does the same thing as the hold down?
Yeah, and you can somewhat affect the timing that way. Not as much as I would like, a little, though. And that really improved my ability, like in that mech fight, to actually get hits in those narrow windows that, in the normal just hold circle to attack a whole lot, you couldn't really do.
Yeah.
So I'm going to have to amend part of my review to include that.
Yeah.
Now, I don't know when they changed that, because when we first started playing the game, it wasn't like that.
No.
I'm glad to see that it did, though.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing, is I have immense respect for the developers of that game, because they clearly listen to the fans.
Oh, yeah.
And
they care about that game.
Oh, they care. And that's part of what I love so much about it, is the care for that game and the story and the characters and just the world in general comes across so clearly.
Yeah. And that's the thing I'm going to make really clear in my review of it, is that, yeah, there were some choices made about it that, on, like, the corporate level, as far as, like, the distribution level, I don't agree with. Those I cannot, in good faith, put at the feet of the developers, though, because clearly those just came from the Square Enix board of directors that were just like, well, we need it at this time. Release it. Have it ready.
Yeah, and whether or not it was ready.
Yeah, so some of the, like, skeevy, you know, charging for DLCs that really just finish plugging holes in the story rather
than adding to the story. That's basically the developers finding a way to put it in.
Yeah, to at least get that content in.
Yeah.
And I'm sure if they were
And
the
that's
ones in
why
charge,
I've actually been really impressed, because some of the free updates for 15 has added in new content
that otherwise
would have been paid DLC from other developers.
Totally.
they are sticking stuff in that I would have expected, especially since they'd already told everyone that Royal was going to be a thing.
Yeah.
That I would have expected to have waited until Royal came out. And they didn't. They put it in as a free update for all the versions.
Ah, damn it. I should have known.
Ghost says, I think I'm at 9 or maybe 8, so not too much more to go.
Oh, so you're right in the middle of the dip.
You're right in the middle of the dip, but you're going to get to the rise pretty soon.
Yeah. I would say chapter 13 is when it really starts
picking back
to come into its own.
Chapter 14.
Oh, chapter 14 will tear your heart out. It gutted me. Your face.
It gutted me. So it's one of those tear your heart out and then crush it in front of you before your body knows it's dead. Like, that's the kind of feel that gave me.
It did my goofy face. Oh, dang it, it skipped it. I flew off the side after.
Did you really?
Yep.
And that's what happens when I look down at chat. But yeah, like, that's part of what I love about 15 isn't necessarily the entirety of the game, but the characters and the full story is what really...
The characterization, I would say, is some of the strongest in any game in a long time.
Yeah.
Because they feel like such real people.
Mm-hmm. And
that's difficult to communicate in a game.
Yeah. And just there are just small details that they put in that really make them feel like honest to goodness people. Like they have, you know, hobbies. They have favorite foods. And honestly, the favorite food mechanic didn't need to be in there.
No. It's just a minor little stat thing.
But they put it in there, and now the characters have favorite foods.
Yeah, exactly.
Noctis absolutely loathes all vegetables, especially beans.
Beans. Prompto, like, I love that kid. His taste in food, though.
Oh, man. Ghost says, what did you guys play it on? We played it on PS4.
Yeah, we originally played it on PS4.
We now have Windows Edition, which is Royal Edition by another name for PC, which is what we're playing it on now.
I don't think you caught any of those PC streams, Ghost.
Most of them are live. I think there was one or two that I'm waiting for thumbnails on.
Okay. So yeah, if you want to see how it plays, like, the first stream, we spent about half of it tweaking graphic settings.
Uh-huh.
Because it's crazy on PC. It supports up to 8K.
Mm-hmm.
Like, clearly our setup does not support that. So I was trying to find a good, like, happy medium of...
Yeah. It's the first game that we really can't full graphics it.
Edie is no longer a titan that can chew up whatever I throw at her. My poor computer, she didn't have the ability to run it on maximum.
Or even close to maximum.
No,
it's
only like 2/3 of the way up.
We really had to make some sacrifices.
Yeah. That's why, like, if you watch any of those streams, all the edges on things
are really sharp and kind of jagged.
Yeah, because I turned off most of the aliasing, or the anti-aliasing there.
Because it tanked our...
Yeah, and getting rid of the anti-aliasing really helped. So, unfortunately, I just have to live with jaggy edges for the PC version.
Mm-hmm. So it says, speaking of new content, the sub-simulator Cold Water is getting a new campaign set in the South China Sea.
Oh,
urge
cool.
to buy growing! And Gus says, been busy as hell. Half the time I come home just to sleep.
Oh, yeah, as much as you're training, I
don't
fault you one on.
Which controls are better? I only have it on Xbox One so far.
That's difficult for me to answer without getting a lot of personal bias into the mix.
Because we don't really like Xbox controllers?
Yeah, I don't like the way that they fit my hand. So, personally, I prefer the PlayStation controller for
Which we use on the PC edition.
Yeah, because we got the Steam PC version of it, and through Steam... since they added the ability to actually play natively with PS4 controllers midway through last year. I just play with a PS4 controller on PC,
and it plays
just
like...
Oh, yeah.
It's
just like the console version.
Except, of course, with some of the updates.
Yeah.
Some of the controls.
So, you're not forced to try and do it with mouse and keys or anything if you don't want to.
No. We haven't tried the mouse and keys because we got so used to how to play it on console, but it just... It wouldn't make sense to relearn the game.
Because I've gotten really good at controlling it with a PS4 controller, so, like, why would I change?
Yeah. But, yeah. I was very happy that we got it on Steam, because that's where you got, like, a whole bunch of the fashion fantasy packs. That was the special for Steam, was that you would get some of the clothing, cosmetic packs, which I preferred over...
the car stuff.
Yeah, the car stuff. Because I didn't really like the decals you got for the car stuff. That was the only other thing. If I had liked the regalia stuff better, that might have made it hard to pick.
Because I know you're going to want to talk about it. Speaking of...
I have a regalia shirt!
I knew it. I knew I wouldn't even have to lead in with any more than that, and you'd know.
We went to Think Geek last week, but after a lunch date, because we felt like walking, but it was too hot outside to go for a walk, and we've been trying to walk because it, you know, stretches out the muscles and stuff, and we also want to be a bit healthier, so... Walking around a mall for a while, hitting some Pokestops, you know, seemed like a good plan. And we decided to go into the Think Geek store at our local mall because we'd never been in one before, and they were having a shirt sale, which was buy one get the second
for free. And there were $20 shirts.
And they were $20 shirts. $10 for really, you know, for a graphic tee. That's actually a really good price. So we were looking through it, and then I saw the regalia symbol on the front of a shirt and like froze, and it was too big. It was not the right size for me, but I grabbed it anyway because I was like, I literally went mine, and then proceeded to search through the rest of the sizes to find one that was actually my size. But I didn't care if it was too big. If that was the only one they had, that was the one I was gonna get. I got one in my size. I was super excited, and I spent the rest of that day with a stupid grin on my face.
It was actually a pretty classy design, too.
It is!
Like, it's really understated. So, like, if you don't know what you're looking at, you wouldn't realize you're looking at a video game t-shirt.
No, and I really like the regalia symbol anyway, because it's based on a rune.
Yeah.
A Norse rune for protection.
I'm gonna get you!
And it's just really pretty, you know? It's just, it's a pretty symbol. But yes, I spent the rest of that day with this stupidest grin on my face, and every now and then I'd look down at the bag I was holding and just get that that happy expression. He would just laugh and shake his head at me.
Oh my god, nightmare. But, give me a second here, man.
But I didn't expect to find 15 merch.
No, I didn't either.
Because they haven't actually done much 15 merch in the States.
No, most of their promotional stuff is all over in Japan.
Mm-hmm. Ghost says, ooh, you spoke the magic words. I prefer PS4 controller way better than Xbox. PC plus PS4 equals hell yes.
Yeah,
definitely going to rebuy.
Yeah, if you haven't tried
Royal,
it,
the Windows, the Windows edition is actually a fair price, I would say.
Oh yeah, it is. It's, what is it, 40 or 50 now?
Yeah, I think it's one of those.
And yeah, speaking more vaguely, the controller use through Steam, you can do that with any game. Even games that don't natively have controller support, you can create a control profile through Steam's interface that will map the control inputs of a PS4 controller to the inputs of a standard, quote, Windows controller, which is an Xbox controller, and essentially fool the game into thinking that it's receiving a mouse and keys input
because
it's
not,
like, processing it through like a controller emulator sort of thing, so that you can do it with a controller and the game doesn't necessarily think you are.
Yeah. Of course, it 15 does have
support, of course,
so you don't have to fool it. It knows what it's doing.
No, a lot of like classic games though don't have
native
controller
that
support because they're, you know, antiquated.
Mm-hmm.
You can play it now with a controller though.
Yeah.
Like when we go and we play, because we're going to do this at some point, all the classic Sonic games. I am not going to do that on mouse and keys. I'm going to do that with a controller.
Yeah. Scott says, I know that feels so much. Is anyone else having issues connecting to the Steam store servers?
I don't know.
I haven't really checked.
Yeah, I mean, I haven't sat at my desk in almost 3 weeks now.
Ghost says, holy crap, sweet. I have got to find that option. That is awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You have to do a setup thing for
like
it.
Like a setup process.
Yeah, like check around. I'm sure there's 1,003 tutorials. You know, do a Benny Run.
Benny Run!
I know you have to start it with Steam in, what do they call it? The big picture mode. And that initializes the controller profile thing.
Mm-hmm.
And then once you set it up in big picture mode, then it's just plug and play after that.
Yeah.
Sometimes
you do have to set it up first.
Yeah, some games are a little finicky. You'll have to restart Steam after you've plugged the controller in, and then it'll work properly. So if you have any issues, try that straight away.
Yeah.
In general, though, it's actually worked really well.
Yeah. So it says, okay, sorted. I had to restart the Steam client. Okay. Sometimes restarting things fixes issues.
Well, especially Steam.
I've noticed that sometimes it doesn't like being open for like I've had it open for too long and it doesn't like it, so you have to kind of like reinitialize.
Yeah, like for my Steam, I don't know why, I've only got like a 1 day window for it to do any auto updates. After that amount of time has passed, it'll just auto pause, even if I tell it to resume any update that is queued. Like, I'll have to restart Steam if I want it to update anything.
Yeah.
Which is weird. It's just, it's a quirk of my setup that I've learned to live
yep.
with.
So yeah, I would definitely recommend Windows Edition for Steam.
Oh yeah.
Specifically.
Definitely. Like, I think there's a GOG version, there's an Origin version.
There is an Origin version. No, and there's not a GOG, just a Windows, or a Microsoft.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, the Microsoft Store.
Yeah, the Microsoft Store version, Origin version, and then there's the Steam version. I prefer the Steam version simply because it adds it to your library. I suppose Origin probably wouldn't be too bad either, because it's also on their library.
Yeah, and Origin has improved over the last few years.
Yeah.
Is there a Uplay version? I don't think there is. Maybe I'm wrong, though.
No, I don't think there was a Uplay version. I do not think they
made a deal.
I wouldn't
want
a
Uplay version.
I do know that they did a deal with the Twitch Prime thing.
Yeah.
So you can get the crazy chocobo.
Which is a little goofy, and I don't want it. It's
goofy, and I don't want it, but I think it's, to me, that's a good step, because that means they are partnering with Twitch.
Yeah, which to me is an important thing, because it means that Square, a Japanese company, that are traditionally, these days, antiquated in their approach to independent content creators online, intentionally partnering with an independent creator platform.
Mm-hmm.
Which
is a really great step.
Yes, because it's usually these days the Japanese companies from like the large AAA crowd that cause copyright and claim issues on YouTube, and so to see Square embracing that rather than resisting it
is really
a
great
huge
news.
Relief.
And it's also why I was super excited that not just that Royal Edition was going to exist, because I was happy about that. But because Windows Edition, specifically Windows Edition, was going to exist.
That's them embracing the Western PC market.
Yes, and that's something that they didn't do before, and that gives me a lot of hope for the future of it.
Yep.
Simply because I feel like that PCs are really where it's at. I mean, yes, of course, there's always going to be console players.
Oh, yeah.
But the PC market is...
Oh, it's exploding.
It's huge.
Yeah.
So
these days, you can't ignore it.
Yeah, and it makes me happy to see that Square Enix isn't ignoring it.
Yeah.
And they're embracing it, doing mod support eventually.
Yeah. Native mod support through Steam Workshop.
Yeah, like...
Like, that's them cutting a deal with Valve.
Yeah, they're cutting a deal with Valve. They're allowing users to make content for their game and natively supporting them.
Yeah, which they have never done.
Mm-hmm.
Very few Japanese companies at all have done.
So, like... That's why I was super excited, not just for Royal Edition, which I was excited for because more story stuff, more content in general.
Yeah.
For 15, which is my favorite Final Fantasy game, other than 7. It's kind of trying.
I noticed you hesitated to add that addendum.
It's trying to. it's purely my nostalgia talking on the 7 front. If I didn't have the nostalgia for 7, 15 would be my favorite Final Fantasy. Just, I'm going to admit that, and people are going to hate me for it, but I'm going to admit it. And it's 100% the characters.
Oh.
Like, 100%.
Oh, yeah.
But, so, of course I was excited that Royal Edition was going to be a thing anyway. But to find out about the Windows version, and then the mods, and then working with Steam, and then later on with Twitch.
And just the fact that we haven't had... any copyright claims at all.
No, not even when we're streams. Not even when we're driving around in the Regalia playing FF music.
Yeah, like clearly copyrighted music that any other company would just demolish us with copyright claims for. Not a single one of our streams of 15 has had any copyright issue whatsoever.
No.
And I really expected them to.
We did too. Or rather, I did too. And it's just, it's super refreshing and really exciting to see for the future of Square Enix as a developer.
Yeah.
It makes me really extra excited for the 7 remake. Simply because I'm hoping that this means that the 7 remake will launch with a PC version also. Yeah. Like, not just...
I mean, it's on the Unreal Engine, so I'd imagine it probably will.
Well, I mean, if they can make 15 work, they can make the 7 remake work, because it's the same thing.
Yeah.
Like, we rewatched...
Looking at that trailer, we're like, whoa.
The gameplay trailer for the Final Fantasy 7 remake. That's 15 with a 7 skin. And we're suddenly like... Because we hadn't played 15 when we first saw those.
Yeah.
But we watched it again for the first time after playing 15 and went, whoa!
Yeah.
We know those mechanics.
Oh, yeah.
But, so I'm really excited that Square Enix is taking the stance they are with, like, supporting independent, you know, users via mods, via Twitch, and going for the PC market, which I think will help them monetarily and longevity-wise.
Yeah. I'm also curious to see... I wish I could remember the name of it. What will come out of Hajime Tabata's new studio that he was given after completing work on FF15.
Yeah, which I think they are still working on 15 DLC.
He was the director for 15, for those that don't know.
Mm-hmm.
And I've seen a lot of comments that are just like, oh, great, well, I know anything, you know, avoid anything that comes out of that studio now. I'm like,
no, because the reason 15 is as good as it is because he made it that way.
Exactly.
He's the reason it's good at all.
The reason 15 is incomplete and rushed in certain points has nothing to do with Tabata or his people. It has to do with the Square board of directors putting an unreasonable delivery time on a game that was just remade for the third time and expecting a huge game with that kind of graphical fidelity and a long FF-length story to get put out in just a 3-year turnaround.
And that's not how that works.
No, hell no. Like, if that game had another couple of years, or at least 1 year in the oven...
Even just 1 year.
We'd have so much stronger a game.
Well, we would have probably Royal Edition.
Yeah.
Probably with a bit more.
With the DLCs that aren't DLCs, they're just part of the game.
Mm-hmm.
As I'll agree, they should have been.
Yeah. But yeah.
So, like, I don't think as far as creative talent and even, like, the monetary aspect of things... Any of that fault lies with Tabata himself.
No,
it lies with the Square directors.
I guarantee you, he and his team are the ones that are giving the free updates added stuff that should have probably just been in Royal.
Yeah. So given the amount that they were able to produce in the limited window and with the limited support that they were able to for 15, I'm excited to see what they're able to do for any projects that they start with their own ideas, not just picking up something that some other creative director started and then couldn't finish because of medical reasons, because that's what went on with 15. Tetsuya Nomura started 13 Verses and then due to medical problems couldn't finish it, and that's when it got rebranded into 15.
Yep.
So, like, 15 was never really, from its total inception, Tabata's thing.
No,
he just finished someone else's work.
But he still clearly loved it and put everything he had into it.
He made it his own. It didn't start that way.
No,
though.
It didn't. So I want to see what happens when he starts it.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. I want to see what comes out of something creative that he and his team conceptualize and that they then actualize and execute start to finish. Because I think there's real talent there.
And it's also clear to me that the studio listens to the players.
Yes.
Because some of the DLC that they've announced that they're probably going to do is stuff that they've heard that the players really wanted to see this person's story. So they didn't have a plan for that. Like the episode Arden.
Yeah.
They did not have a plan for episode Arden originally.
Or episode Luna.
Or episode Luna. But people wanted to see what... happened, like, they wanted their stories,
so
they're making it. And, like, that to me just shows how much they actually care.
I am curious to see what will come of a certain question that he asked at, I don't remember exactly which, it was a convention, I think in Japan, that was posed to a crowd of Final Fantasy fans, asking what kind of ending they would like to FF15. He said this after they had already announced Royal Edition. So...
DLC?
DLC? Sequel, maybe? Like, who knows what the hell... FF15
Wrath of the Inferno!
Yeah.
15-2!
What was he fishing for with that question?
People went insane, didn't they?
Oh, the people are theorizing like crazy about what the hell he meant with that. I mean, we'll never know until he does it. Still, though, it's like...
15-2.
The game
please,
is supposedly
you pushed,
finished, so
there
why
were
are
two
you asking...
sequels to 13. Give me 15-2.
Yeah.
Please. Please.
Because we're actually going to run like our own version of a sequel to it as a tabletop campaign and test the D20 Final Fantasy rules that we found a website that's really good for.
I just... Please. Please. Tabata-san. Square Enix. 15-2-1.
I have a mighty need!
Shield says Sims 4 and its DLCs are on sale right now up to 50% off on Origin.
Oh, that's a really good deal.
But I don't have extra money right now. Because I bought NT.
Yeah. Anyone that may have kicked around the idea of
don't
getting...
buy Dissidia NT. Don't do it. It's not worth the price.
If you really
get
want...
it used for like $15 at some point.
I was going to say 10.
I was giving it the benefit of the doubt, okay?
If you really want a good Final Fantasy Dissidia experience, get Final Fantasy Duodecim for the PSP, and then get the cable hookups
to hook it to the TV.
Export its audiovisual to a TV, and then just play that.
Of course, if you don't have a PSP, then...
Well, yeah, still though.
If you have a PSP, get Dissidia Duodecim. It's actually really good and made me like characters that I didn't like before.
Yeah, I'll come out and say a thing that might piss some people off, and to you, I am not sorry. Final Fantasy Dissidia Duodecim is 10 times the game that NT is.
Oh,
come at me.
A lot of people agree with you.
I know a lot of people do. There are some people who don't, though, and they are very ardent in their disagreement with me on
that
point.
Final Fantasy Opera Omnia
yes.
is a better Dissidia than Dissidia NT.
I agree.
And it's free to play.
It's a free to play mobile game knockoff turn based thing. And it's still
it's a
stronger game than NT. It's not as pretty. That's the only thing it isn't that NT is, though.
Yep. I love adorable Noctis in NT, but that is literally it.
And he's only.
He's
in
only
just a
in
few
like
cutscenes.
I know, and that's the thing is everybody's only in a few cutscenes.
Yeah.
Like
Cloud of Darkness has one speaking line,
and Noctis is in like three scenes.
Yeah. Kane isn't even in the storyline. Neither is Ramza. Neither is Ace, the new character alongside Ramza.
And Noctis.
And my God, can I just? I'm gonna go off on a little rant here for a second.
Brace
yourselves.
Just
say the voice director for Dissidia NT never needs to direct for another game again in a vocal capacity. Because whatever the hell they told to poor... Oh, God, I'm trying to draw the sentence out because I'm fighting to find his name. God, what am I... Phil Lamar. Whatever the hell that voice director told Phil Lamar was wrong. Because for those that don't know, Phil Lamar is a prolific and very, very talented voice actor. He's voiced probably a dozen characters that you've known and enjoyed and never knew it was him, because he has an extremely wide range, he's extremely talented, and yet, when he voiced Ramza in NT, it sounds awful. So I know Phil is a stronger actor than that delivery. He was told to do it that way, and whoever gave him that order was wrong to do so.
Ghost says, what in the heck is NT? It's the newest Dissidia title, which is basically the fighting version
It's like Final Fantasy Smash Bros.
Yeah, it's Final Fantasy Smash Bros, basically. NT is a sort of semi-co-op version.
Yeah,
where you have a team of three.
Yeah, it's 3v3, and it's for PS4. Although previous Dissidia games
were
for mobile platforms.
And they were 1v1.
Yeah. And this is the first, like, large production value game in the series that they've done. And I was really hoping for a lot more than we got.
That's because it wasn't Square Enix who developed it. That's the problem.
Yeah, it was Koei and...
Team Ninja.
Team Ninja, yeah. And Team Ninja, I'm sorry, I'm going to get crucified for saying this. They've fallen a long way since the old Ninja Gaiden days.
Because that was... Like, NT is not good.
No, it's really not. Like, I expected more out of Team Ninja than what we got.
Yeah, and the thing is I love Dissidia. Specifically Dissidia Duodecim, which is the original Dissidia better. Like, it is the story of the original Dissidia with more to it.
Yeah.
Basically, it was a remake.
And it has a long campaign.
It's like 70-plus hours, probably.
Or more than that.
More than that.
Because every character has their a own story mode unto themselves. And it's like at least 10 chapters a piece.
And it's several hours for all
of them. Oh, yeah, absolutely. You'll spend an entire day doing one character's story. And it has a large roster.
Yeah. And Ghost says, what's the point of Final Fantasy without story? That's the thing. Dissidia Duodecim has story. It literally has... It might as well be a Final Fantasy unto itself.
The concept, in a nutshell, is... a lot of the iconic heroes and villains from every numbered entry in the franchise are somehow, like, mysteriously transported to another plane of existence
by a couple of deities who are at war with each other.
A couple of opposed deities are there, and they essentially claim the heroes and the villains, respectively, although some of those lines do get crossed, to fight each other for their cosmic war, and... There are memory issues for the characters. They can't remember the worlds that they're from or exactly who they are, and they come to discover that stuff throughout the story.
Yeah.
So it shows some interesting aspects and facets of characters removed from the context of their original stories that those originals wouldn't have ordinarily explored. So it's a cool concept.
And it actually works really, really well. Yeah. I think of the characters that we did manage to play through on Duodecim, because we haven't actually beaten the story of Duodecim.
No, we haven't.
but we've played, like...
We're a long way into it. We still haven't finished it. Yeah. That should tell you something.
But all the characters that we've played the stories of in Duodecim, they're all really good.
Yeah, they are.
Like
it made me like Vaughn.
Mr. Cardboard.
Yeah.
I really liked him.
Yeah.
Like, it made me rethink how...
It's making me... tolerate Onion Knight even.
Yeah. Which is impressive. And Zidane.
Yeah. Like, still trying to get around
the fact that
committing that
version
to memory.
Of the I'm still upset that Tidus is apparently
I refuse to call him Tidus.
I refuse.
I will not.
But yeah, like Duodecim is a fantastic game.
It really is.
Like, the controls are tight,
they're
fun. You can customize everybody with multiple movesets. You can make it exactly what you want, complete with gear and extra abilities. And then there's the story, which is good in and of itself.
One little customization point that I feel is worth mentioning. For any fighting game fans out there, the holy grail, at least for me, in fighting games, is the ability to customize movesets. So few games have done it. And yet, it allows for such a personalized experience that, at least to me, because I like the fine detail aspect of that kind of thing, and really making a character's style my own, that game lets you do it.
Yeah.
And to see, because all that was gone in NT.
Yeah,
you could not customize your moveset aside from your one HP attack, which is like your finishing move.
Yeah, like there was only like a handful of customizey things, and they were very minor.
Oh yeah.
Like, they didn't matter.
You couldn't change your moveset. All you could change was your finisher.
Yeah. It was ridiculous.
That was a huge step in reverse.
And the story of NT, I hesitate to call it that, was super short.
Oh, it's short, it's flimsy, it's forced, it's unfinished.
And the worst part is the god that I think we're supposed to like.
Yeah.
I actually hate her.
Oh god, she's insufferable!
Materia is like the worst thing.
Team Spiritus
all
the way.
We need to, like, all the heroes just need to move sides. It's fun.
Hashtag Team Spiritus, man.
He's
supposedly the villain. I don't think he is.
I don't think he is. Grendel says, transcending history and the world, a tale of souls and swords eternally retold. Goddamn, the armor break mechanic is terribly Japanese.
Oh, it really is.
Suddenly
all of your armor is gone.
Yeah. But yeah, so... Duodecim, 100%. Get it if you own a PSP. If you don't own a PSP, but you can find a cheap PSP,
consider getting it if you like Final Fantasy games.
Consider getting it if you like Final Fantasy.
Because it's really good.
Do not get NT.
No.
Don't bother with it.
It's NT is a pretty mess.
Literally, there are two things that I got out of NT that I liked. Actually, no, three things, but one is kind of weird. Okay, so the three things that I liked in NT.
I know what one of them is.
Is adorable freaking Noctis. Because he is just such a cinnamon bun in that game. Like, he doesn't have very many scenes, but the scenes he has, he's just stinking adorable and also very intelligent about it. Transcending the lines between good and, like, the quote-unquote good side and then the bad side to try and save the world, because good kid Noctis. And then there's Gagai Garland.
Yes!
Who I am convinced he's not actually a villain in NT.
Because for those that don't know, Garland is the classic antagonist of Final Fantasy I.
Mm-hmm.
And yet, he isn't really villainous.
Like,
in
he
NT.
Sounds super, like, his voice is deep and resonant and kind of intimidating. But, like,
it's Chris Sabat. I mean, that's the guy that voiced Vegeta and Piccolo.
And then, like, afterwards, you know, when you other members of your team do well, he's like, "Well done."
Well done.
And if you have, like, young characters
the
on your team,
there's no place for children. And it's like, "Oh, you're looking after him."
He was like, "Oh no, you're a child. What are you? Where are the adults?" It's like, why are you here? This is unacceptable. I will destroy them.
The funny thing is, like, I know that line was supposed to sound demeaning, like he's calling the enemies children. The way it was delivered,
but
though...
But the thing is it only shows up when you have young characters on your party, doesn't it?
No. That game's not that detailed. What are you talking about?
It seemed like it, though.
That happens all the time.
But yeah, like, but it's... When you put everything else together with it, it doesn't seem to me. It sounds more
like
he's actually concerned.
The delivery intonation didn't quite come across like an insult.
No, he was like, the battle place is no place for children. Like, kind of like semi-horrified.
Yeah.
Like, a little bit like, I can't believe we're doing this. What
the
hell?
Why are all these teenagers here? Why are teenage heroes such a thing in Japanese storytelling?
Yeah.
I was going to say Japanese storytelling. For some reason, I was like,
wow.
Why am I pronouncing it this way? Abort!
Yeah. So, yeah, those are the two major things that I liked in NT. And then the third minor one is I liked Jekt and Tidus's.
Oh, their relationship was cool. Although
it was adorable.
It was so short.
That's why it's a minor one.
Yeah.
Because it was just, I was like, oh, they're reconnecting! It's adorable! This thing that I wish could have actually happened in their story. But, it was so minor.
Yeah,
like
the whole giant monster thing.
Yeah, the whole giant monster thing
kind
of ruins that. But yeah. Grendel says, to be fair, most of the Soul Calibur cast is skimpy enough that it doesn't make much of a difference.
It really doesn't.
It's true.
There are a few characters that you can hardly tell.
Saved says, hello, long time no see.
Hey, I always made it.
And Sarah says, Noct is always cinnamon bun.
Yes.
He is. In NT, to try and get people's attention, he raises his hand! Because these are all, like, half of them are definitely older than him, done that, and he's just like,
and they're in, like, ancient armor, speaking in really stilted language.
So he lifts his hand and says, can someone tell me how to get home?
Does anyone have cell phone signal here?
like, literally, like, half the time, he's just like, I just want to go home, my friends are going to be worried about me. And then, like, the other half of the time, he's like, man, Prompto would love to be able to take a picture of this. And, like, other stuff like that. And there was a moment when they needed to talk to Materia, their patron god. But they were too far away from her place, so they knew that the other god could essentially...
He's got his magic Skype.
Yeah, basically. And could use magic to allow for instant communication. And because there was a world-ending threat on the world they're all on and don't know how to get off of, he's like, maybe we should go and see if he'll let us use it.
Can we use Spiritus's communication magic? And then,
Warrior
of Light and Garland fight for a little while, and then they realize, oh, there is a greater threat. So, yeah,
Garland's
sure,
like,
I'll take you to Spiritus.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, and Garland's like, a wise... That was a good idea. Sure.
I shall escort you.
I think it was Cecil who was like, will he allow it? And Garland's like, oh yeah. Like, basically just like, of course he will. It's fine. Don't worry about it. I'll bring you there. It's totally good. And I'm like, it's adorable. And Noct is like, maybe we should do that? Like, so practical. I'm like, good kid. Mr. Diplomatic there. I was like...
You were about to say diplomancer, weren't you?
Please forgive me.
Yes. But yeah, I was so happy because he was a cinnamon bun the whole time. Like, Noctis just wanted to go home.
It was just and he so had, short, though.
And Warrior of Light and Cecil were definitely 100% Noct senpais.
Oh, yeah.
And he was like, my senpais. And then they complimented him. And he's just like, senpai noticed me. Like, you know that was what was happening in his head. He was just so cute. And the funny thing that I realized throughout that entire story, he never once let on that he was royalty.
He never told them.
He never told them that he was royalty. Because you know they would have been like, oh, yeah, we should probably use your proper title and everything.
Especially Cecil and Wohl, because they'd have immediately said, oh, I'm Lord Noctis.
Prince Noctis.
Prince, yes.
Your Highness. And Noctis would just be like, no!
God, I was finally away from all this. So he
never tells anybody.
Well, like, he even insists at one point that they call him Noct instead of his full name of Noctis, mm-hmm.
It's adorable.
Clearly, formality is not a really
well. That's because
thing
he respects them.
Yeah,
like he respects them, wants them to respect him.
Yeah.
He just wants to be friends, man. And then he wants to go home to his other friends. Because the intro scene, I swear, he was in the regalia.
And just falls through space.
Yeah, like because he was clearly leaning back
in
a seated position, like the way I would have expect him to, like when you drive around in the regalia. So it's clear that he was in the regalia when whatever transporty thing happened, and he just slams down into the ground and just like, what the hell? Am I dreaming? It's adorable. And Scar says, that moment, you must abort mid-sentence to avoid offending an entire country. Classic Kin.
Not even so much just offending them, more just embarrassing myself with poor pronunciation.
Yes, that too. You know, and it's funny, that happens.
Oh, yeah.
You know, that just sort of happens sometimes.
Yeah,
it's like, you 100% know exactly how to pronounce it. You've pronounced it properly for years, but for some reason your brain just stutters and out comes like the worst pronunciation possible.
Well, and the thing that I find happening a lot with me, like this happens on camera, maybe it's a self-consciousness sort of thing.
Because
it does happen more on camera than
in normal,
ordinary conversation. Because I try to comport myself articulately for anything that's, you know, for public consumption, etc. Because, you know, I like to appear erudite and educated and like I have opinions that I can defend with great articulate thought. Anyway, it's just I start thinking like a sentence or so ahead of
but
my
speech.
But
then it gets garbled
in
the meantime.
Yeah, my mouth confuses what I'm thinking a few words from now with what I'm actually saying right now.
And then it comes out.
Confusion happens.
Mm-hmm. Scott says, also, I totally just bought cold waters. Couldn't resist, huh? That's okay. I couldn't resist after we beat 15. I made
getting
him...
Getting the PC version?
Well, no. Getting the season pass for the DLC.
Oh, yeah.
We went to GameStop.
Yeah. Hashtag no regrets.
No regrets. Except we now have it for free because we got... Because it comes with it on the PC. I don't know if we'll be able to, like, if the other episodes that are that haven't come out yet will be free for Royal users.
I doubt it. Just because they lumped everything that was in the old season pass into Royal.
Yeah.
I think anything else that comes out is going to end up its own thing.
Yeah, I think so too. But
like,
we don't
know. I wish
it
weren't. I suspect
And we're not entirely sure, so don't take that for...
Like, maybe I'm wrong. I don't think I'm wrong.
No. But, no regrets. Even though we technically bought both the game and the season pass twice.
Yeah.
Basically. Still no regrets.
And that's the thing, is I am conflicted as hell about that game, because I have so many issues with it.
And yet, still no regrets.
I still enjoy it enough that I don't regret that.
Like.
And yet. This is like triple and yet. I have hardly raged at a game that hard in like 10 years. So
that should tell you how good the good parts are.
Yes.
That they got past the rage of the other parts that weren't.
The good parts of that game made up for the titanic rage it fueled in me. Mm-hmm. So that should tell you something.
Yeah. And don't worry, I will do Piteous myself.
I will never do it again, so someone's gotta...
I know, but I want to look at it again for our theory video.
Yeah.
Like, I want to see the order things happen in.
Yeah, well, I'm not prepared yet to do a Piteous theory.
No.
Because it's so arcane.
It is so arcane, but we know there's a story to it, because we've been told so by Tabata-san.
Yeah, Tabata has said that it tells a story, he just hasn't said one story.
Yeah, so that's why I want to go back through it
once
we get to chapter 15.
Yeah. The theory stuff that I want to watch really closely is
if anything in chapter 14
the new royal version of the end of the game.
Yeah, does that change? I hope it doesn't. I want
I
love our theory too much.
Yeah, I hope we just see more of
proof.
What we already see.
Yeah.
Just with more like characterization details and
or
stuff
like
that.
Or maybe some more proof that our theory is correct.
Maybe. Like, I mean, I'll take more proof. I'm not really necessarily going to expect it.
Well, because I think we have enough proof anyway to make a fairly strong...
Like, I am convinced of our theory. Mm-hmm. Even though, and this is the weird thing, I would actually prefer it if that theory weren't true.
I wouldn't. 100% I would
not.
It's
just, I think there's enough evidence for it that I can't not
like, we
think
can't,
it's right.
Yeah, like, I think it could be either way.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's whatever you... And there is a possibility that they both are true.
Yeah.
Depending on the method of what I will not go into here.
It's entirely possible.
So it's possible that both our things are...
Yeah, the way that I'm going to phrase it in the theory video that I'm concocting is that this alternate reading is at least a valid interpretation.
Yes.
You know, I'm not going to say that, oh no, you other people, you got it wrong.
You're wrong.
Because maybe you didn't.
I think it's a very valid interpretation, and I think there's enough evidence to say that we could be entirely correct.
Yeah. You know, it could go either way, plausibly. Mm-hmm. And that's what I want to communicate
in
that video.
And I want it to. Also, it bothers me.
What?
His tattoo, because it's, like, scooted to the back of his arm.
Oh, yeah.
It's not, like, centered on his arm. Sorry, that just... I was like...
His Eridan eye.
Yes. It's not centered.
Sorry.
Scott says, my family is constantly frustrated with me because I tend to pronounce things the way an American might rather than how Aussies do. That and using the imperial metric systems interchangeably.
That's a difficult thing to do, though. Like, I'm only just now starting to get a mental gauge for how far a kilometer is. Because
we walk using Pokemon Go as a step counter sort of thing.
Yeah, as I've recovered from the muscle injury, I've found that taking... some lengthy walks each day has actually helped tremendously in stretching those muscles out in a non-strenuous manner. And so Pokemon Go has actually helped to give me an incentive to walk decent distances every day. And I actually, for anyone curious, haven't ever played it until just a couple weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm really loving it.
And
like,
I
it's
used
so
to
good.
Play it, stopped playing it, and now I'm more invested in his version of it than I ever was in the one I had.
Because you played the launch version. That
I did play the
Pidgeys
launch
version. Pidgeys and Rattatas everywhere.
Either Korra or Kia.
I'll do a Korra run and soup everyone.
Soup everyone?
I can't see knife stabs now and not think of soup!
Because we just finished watching Markiplier's playthrough of Evil Within 2.
Oh my god. I know some people got really tired of it. I didn't, though.
I loved the soup.
I loved the recurring soup joke. If you haven't seen it, watch it. It's so good.
So you wanna fight?
Also, that game is way stronger than the original.
Oh, yes. I'm convinced he never leaves STEM.
Yeah, because...
That ending. Mm. That ending. The post-credit scene.
Yeah.
And then the flicker of the STEM thing. I'm like...
Without getting into too many details...
I don't think it's real.
I'll just say that I don't think the story that... we're meant to take at face value in that game is what's really going on. I really don't think it is.
I will be curious to see what DLCs do.
Yes.
So it says a kilometer is 1,000 meters or 1,000,000 millimeters.
Oh yeah, like I know
that
intellectually.
Oh yeah, we know
that.
I didn't have a mental gauge for, like, feeling out.
Because we're so used to feet and miles.
Yeah, like, I could walk for a while at a certain pace and just kind of mentally know, all right, at this point, I've walked a mile. I can feel it. I didn't have a mental feel for a kilometer. Because Pokemon Go is in kilometers in all of its step count stuff.
We've started figuring out where
Yeah, I've started getting a feel for how long that is. And I never had that. So it's kind of cool. And I am completely in full, like, autopilot mode for this game right now.
Well, we've played this so much.
Oh, yeah. Like, all of the characters that I'm good with, I can control in my sleep.
Yeah, Scott says a meter is roughly a yard.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's just a few inches apart from one to the other.
Mm-hmm. But, yeah. Scott says, do you use yards much, or do you use feet and miles more? Feet and miles. Usually.
Yeah, here in the States, commonly, like, for everyday usage, it's feet, miles, inches. For fine detail, for, like, construction projects?
They'll do yards.
Well, I'm like, centimeters.
Well, no, I mean, like,
in.
Like, at, like, if you go to a range, it's usually yards.
Yeah, yeah.
But.
Well, actually, no, at, like, gun ranges, it's now usually in meters.
Is it now meters? It used to be yards.
Yeah, except now, I forget which branches do it. I know the Marine Corps does. They train their range masters, and therefore all of their riflemen, and of course every Marine a rifleman and all that. So all Marines are trained to, like, to see firearm ranges in meters.
Yeah.
So
now ranges are like that too.
Yeah, not all of them, of course. A lot of them are though.
Yeah. And it says, story speaking, have you bothered with the story missions for this? Because this is legitimately some of the worst running I've ever seen in a game. Oh, we've beaten this.
Oh, this game? Oh, yeah. We did this a long time ago.
We've beaten everything this game has to offer.
And trust me, you're not missing much.
No. And we know exactly how terrible it is.
Yeah.
We talked about that earlier this stream.
Yeah. I play this game for the combat and for the character customization. Not at all whatsoever for the story.
No.
Which is a shame, because once upon a time, Soul Calibur had a great story. In the 2 and 3 days. 4 and 5, ooh, that changed.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I would actually say that 3 had one of the strongest stories of any fighting game ever made. And then 4 happened. That had almost no story.
And then 2 had all of those extra modes and...
Well, 2 and 3 also had...
Yeah.
Or they each
had
different extra modes. And that's
yeah.
the thing is... Like, 2 had one sort of totally extra mode thing. 3 had another, even more involved, totally extra mode thing. Because it had, like, almost a strategy, like, hex-taking sort of mode tacked on that was a story totally separate from any of the rest of the Soul Cal stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So it was almost like 2 games in 1.
Yep. And then 4.
And then 4 happened, and it's just like, oh, well, you get Darth Vader and Yoda, and you go fight in a tower with a spooky guy with sword arms. And that was the story, and I'm only paraphrasing the smallest amount, really.
Womp womp. But yes. And then this game just made it even worse.
Yeah.
Because we don't even have the characters that we like so much most of the time.
Yeah. Like, Natsu and... what's her face? The Shanwha replacement.
And Shiba.
God, Shiba. I hate him so much. He is no Keyleth replacement, let me tell you.
No, but... It's not too,
Whoa, shit!
Oh, wow. Wow.
That was me!
I'm trying to think of the name of the Shanwha replacement.
I don't even remember.
I don't remember. But they're just so bad. They're just so bad. And the problem is they use too many modernisms.
They do, yeah. Especially the new Shanghua lady that I can't remember the name of.
She and
she sounds like a mid-2000s Valley girl.
Yeah. And then there's also this particular character that Korra's using the style of, Natsu.
Yeah, yeah.
She also has modernisms.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Like, a lot of them. And I'm just like, why? That doesn't make any sense. That's not a thing. Well, especially
because not everyone in this game talks that way. Like, if they just kind of decided, we don't care, we're going to make everyone talk like normal people
like
today.
Like, modern.
Except they don't. Because a lot of characters in this same game also speak in really, like, stilted, flowery language. So, it just doesn't mesh.
No. And then they kept, like, Maxi for some reason. Like, they replaced Helic and Jeonghwa and Taki, but kept Maxi.
And Maxi, once upon a time, was really important to the Soul Calibur story, and now he's just sort of like, I'm still here!
Sort of. Gendel says, made something fun while I was screwing around, retexturing a mod. I made a kin mask.
Uh-oh. Wait, what?
Uh-oh.
Oh, God! Oh, God, what have you done?
I'm scared.
It's so horrifying. Stand up and show you. Is that actually extrapolated from... Oh, that really does look like a skin tone. Did you actually wrap that from a screenshot of me from, like, Discord or something? Because that's terrifying.
This is horrifying? No, thank you.
For anyone in archive land that's wondering what I'm so scared of right now...
You don't want to know.
It's, I think, the texture of a screen cap of my face stretched over that huge Vault Boy helmet mask thing in Fallout 4.
It's and horrifying, it looks like and I don't like it. Nightmares. I don't like it. It's horrifying, and I don't like it. And I love Kin, because obviously, or I wouldn't have married you, but...
Are you sure? I don't know. I think you just put up with me.
I don't like this. If this was you, we would not be married.
It's a friggin' Lovecraftian caricature. The battle
has finished. Save says, nightmares! I know.
I'm gonna see that thing in my dreams. Just staring at me from out of a dark closet.
Please don't put ideas in my head for my subconscious to use tonight. Why would you do that?
She said as she glances toward the closet. So you wanna
fight? I don't like it. And you even got his blonde patch. Nice work.
Yeah. I mean, if it was ripped from a screenshot of me, then... Yeah, I finally feel freaking human again, too, because I was already due for a haircut when I, like, got injured. Hurt. Like, I was planning on getting a haircut in, like, the next day or so.
But couldn't stand sitting in a chair long enough to get his haircut.
Exactly. So, shit, I did it again.
And Crandall says, hey, Ken, I want to wear your face.
So it was almost another, like, 3 weeks that I had to go already needing a haircut. So, like, I was getting so friggin', like, scruffy and unkempt looking.
And... You were a bit floofy.
Oh, yeah.
You were a bit floofy. And then, I love you, but you were a bit floofy.
I finally got a haircut. I finally, like, trimmed up the facial hair today. I looked at myself in the mirror. I'm like, oh, my God. I actually look like me again.
I don't mind the longer beard, but the hair was getting a bit. Was getting a bit.
For a while there, I was starting to look like a friggin' hobo.
It was the floofy hair.
It was.
It was 100% the floofy hair.
And I know you don't mind the longer facial hair. For me, though, it's... Especially when the mustache part starts going lower than the lip line.
Well, the mustache can be trimmed. I like the beard the way it is.
Okay, gotcha.
It's the mustache part and the part that's by your cheeks on the inside, that can be trimmed.
Yeah.
It's the bottom by your neck that I don't like. I like the longer. Just so you know.
Oh, yeah, I know. And I've known for a long time that, strangely enough, you like my facial hair longer than I like it.
Uh-huh. But I am with you on the mustache. If it's lower than the lip line, please cut it.
Because then it starts getting in the way of drinking and
gets in the way of other kisses. Things. Yeah. Hey, I will own the fact that I like kissing you, okay? We are married, I'm allowed to say that.
Uh-oh.
And Grenna says, nah, actually, I just scrawled the beard onto a mask I was already modding.
Oh, wow.
It's actually just a bunch of textures I ripped online, layered over a color palette, not your skin.
you did a good job.
So that's brilliant. I'll post an updated version soon.
Oh, God! No! Why'd I have to give him the idea?
No, why did you say anything?
It's because I thought it's what it was. It looked really convincing.
I'm scared now. teen tiefling.
I'm actually a little sad, too, that the Grumps and Markiplier each recently started up Turbo Dismount again for the first time in, like, a year plus. Uh-huh. Well, the first time ever for the Grumps. And I had the thought of, hey, I could do some more Turbo Dismount again. I haven't done the whole Paco Batbot thing in a long time. That'd be fun.
Except
and
now
then
it
they
will
just
be.
Did it. Now I'm going to get 1,003 comments.
You're
just copying Markiplier. Because I don't get enough of that just for having a deep voice. Yeah, I'm calling you out, YouTube comments. Yeah.
Like you can help having a voice that's as deep as it is when you're a big guy.
Let me tell you, I get these two comments at least 3 times a week. You're copying Markiplier, and you look like Seth Rogen. I know!
Calm thyself. It says, my mustache goes about 10 times slower than the rest of my face. Is that normal?
Hey, I mean, everyone's facial hair patterns grow differently.
Everybody's hair grows differently.
Oh, yeah, totally.
That's everybody's like my, nails grow differently, and, like, it's just...
My friend who's a Marine, he now shaves his head totally clean, cue ball, all gone, because after he went through boot, and they made him shave his head, he realized
it didn't
after
grow back.
The fact that the full head of hair that he did have was not returning. So
he's just going full cue ball now.
He now just shaves his head completely.
Grendel says, should have everything but the sideburns. I mean, your head too. Smooth, bald, just sideburns.
Oh god, no.
And then Grendel says, Vespa!
No, bop, bop! I think that and Stalker Mode are like...
They're your
memes. My channel's version of Jack's old, like a boss! You know.
That and, I am so upset with myself.
What?
The girl.
You're reaching
his,
for.
His,
Oh, Betty.
Betty, yes. Yeah. You're in, the Vespa's kind of the... Shut up, nurse!
Yeah. I know what's best. Man, I miss Jax Old Skate 3 stuff.
I remember.
I'm gonna rewatch
that
at some point.
Rewatch that, yeah.
Wait, that's about
you
the
exist
time.
Only so my sword skewers. I don't think that's true,
that's,
sir.
That's not very nice.
That's not nice, and I don't think that's true. And how dare you say that to Korra? Her adoptive dad is gonna kick your butt.
I started right? actually. Oh hell yeah!
Right, her adoptive dad is gonna kick his butt.
My dad could be a poodle.
Hey, her dad could.
He really could, yeah. Yeah, I started watching Jack around the time he was doing his Skate 3 and his GTA stuff. I still remember, though, the first video of his I ever watched is his VR Oculus Rift Mirror's Edge video.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. It was stomach churning.
Yeah, Grendel says, my thing was always that classic Mjolnir. Yes, the Mjolnir.
God, and that's from, like one of the first series I ever
did. I love Mjolnir, though.
Oh, yeah.
The hammer with the yellow wrapping.
Yeah. Hammer! Because that's from Estranged.
Uh-huh. Grendel says, I wish I still had that Fallout New Vegas mod I made with the t-shirts. I know.
I've still got a copy of it if you want me to send it to you.
You should probably do that. Scott goes, where's the blacksmith?
Yeah, God.
And that one comes back Jesus. All the time. And Beat a Blow.
The Beat a Blow thing, jeez. I don't even remember what game that was from.
The Beat a
Blow?
Something
Nightmares?
Yeah, that was the one where you were going through procedurally generated...
It was the Underground Dungeon. Like, I remember what the game looks like. I don't know what it was called, though.
It was Something Nightmares.
Something Nightmares.
I don't remember where's the Blacksmith came from.
That was from...
Like, I can imagine what was happening when you first...
It's the same thing that Le Monstinaire was from. Because it was a French game, I think. Oh, shit! I triggered his ult!
Uh-oh. Oh!
No! Ow.
Does her dad need to beat him up?
Maybe. Let's see if I can finish this. If not, she's gonna call adoptive daddy.
Yep.
Eh. Ow.
And she is a character I never expected to have.
Because
she is actually an NPC adopted by the PCs from when I GM'd. Victory belongs to the last horse. I thought they were going to kill her.
100%
thought they were going to kill her. They did not kill her, and she became a character that they then adopted.
Yeah.
She is now their mascot.
I threw a wrench in her plans because I was actually playing a really, like, truly good character. So, to me, that means you do not shoot first, ask questions later.
Yeah.
That means you present yourself, you give them a warning and a chance to stand down, and if they do, you let them.
Yeah. And so, I expected them to kill her, or the character that became her. They didn't, so I scrapped everything I had for that because it wouldn't have worked for a dialogue scene.
Yeah.
And made it up on the fly.
So, speaking of, I'll play as her adoptive dad here, yeah. Corbin.
So it says, here's something interesting. All these Mark memes we're talking about came from Markiplier animated series. It actually didn't. No, those animated videos are based on actual videos that he made.
Yep.
So most of the major memes got turned into a Markiplier anime.
They were animated because they were already popular as catchphrases amongst the fanbase.
Mm-hmm. So basically, there's going to be an animated for pretty much all of the major catchphrases eventually. I'm waiting for the soup.
Oh god, I want a soup animated compilation. I want it so much.
Because I guarantee you it's coming.
Oh yeah. The special is green peas!
But yeah, so this is Korra's adoptive father. Uh-huh. Also, Korra was not meant to have a similar name to Legend of Korra.
Nah,
it was literally, I had no name for her because...
Just made it up on the fly.
Yeah. Because, it wasn't supposed to be a dialogue scene.
It wasn't even supposed to be a female character,
No, it wasn't.
It, yeah.
It was because, as I was making it up, it seemed, she seemed more female.
Yeah.
So she just became female. And then they asked what her name was, and I go, oh shit, mentally. Like,
I knew I was kind of putting you on the spot when I asked. I just kind of wanted to needle you a little.
It's fine. It worked out.
Yeah, it worked out perfectly.
It worked out.
You did amazingly well for your first major GM session. Seriously.
So she didn't have a name. And I was just like, she didn't have a name or a personality or anything. Because she was supposed to be a combat encounter. Because that's what my parents were in on this, as was Miss T and, of course, Ken. That was the party. And my mom, I love her to death. Like, love that woman. But when she plays games, she is hardcore, give me a big weapon and let me wail on things.
She's a little on the murder hobo side.
That's how she plays her games. She does get into story, like, on PC games.
Yeah.
Like, she'll go full hog into story, but if it comes to the combat part, she wants a big weapon that does a lot of damage, and she wants to fight things. That's how she plays. So I expected... Like, most likely.
That same session, I was playing a ranger, this guy, that is actually a capable person dealing with animals. He has a fair amount in the handle animal skill. And we came across this nest of giant spiders, and I knew, however I was playing the character, that ordinarily, handle animal is not an applicable skill against what's classified as vermin.
Mm-hmm.
However, the character doesn't necessarily know that, so I was like,
it's not mechanically.
Yeah.
And I decided that giant spiders, because spiders are actually fairly intelligent, so I decided that giant spiders, since bigger spiders tend to be more intelligent than the smaller spiders, anyway, in the real world.
So I had him offer up a chunk of meat to this spider, because we didn't need to fight it, we just needed to go through a doorway near it.
Yeah, I decided that it made sense enough, so I was going to let him do it.
And I made a strong handle animal roll, and it started to retreat. And then from the crouched character over his shoulder comes sailing the crossbow bolt into its face. And I can still picture in my head exactly the expression on his face in that moment. And it's just that dejected, just sort of sigh.
Yeah, so I expected that to be, you know, everything, right? That's not what happened with Korra. So she became essentially the ward of the party. And he's essentially adopted her.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah. Training her, clothing her. She was in rags before.
Mm-hmm.
Giving her shoes.
And a coat.
And a coat. His old coat, which...
And a knife.
Yep. So it's, I did not plan on there being a GM PC. And she is four levels lower than they are, because she is level one and they are level five. Uh-huh. But she apparently exists now, so that's just how it's going to be. And it's fine. It's totally fine. Scarlet asks, what are your favorite Mark and Jack animated videos? Ooh. Mine are for Jack the Forest and Mark anything by Cranbrusher, the stop-motion dolls.
Cranbrusher does great jobs.
Okay, I don't know for Jack. I know for Mark. My favorite, I think, for Mark is some of the Five Nights at Freddy's.
Yeah, the FNAF animated stuff.
No,
good.
No, I've got it. It's the tearful leaving behind Tiny Box Tim.
Oh, yes! Oh, the Tiny Box Tim animated was so good.
Yes, the Tiny Box Tim.
I don't actually know for Jack. I haven't actually watched too many of his animated things.
I can tell you 100% for Game Grumps.
Yes.
It's the I'm a rocket ship.
Yeah. I'm a fucking rocket ship. Flying through the stars at the speed of light. Oh, yeah. Like, it's so good!
It's
and
so
the
good.
Animation is really touching. Like, it's so emotionally well put together.
I like that one. This guy, so the little guy just pole dancing on a spear.
Pretty much.
And that, and the character we're fighting right now is the one that the style comes from.
Yeah. And the character that I just perfected on is the replacement for Killick, a once upon a time respectable staff wielding character from this series. And then this kid happened. Yeah, your little Son Goku knockoff. Yeah. That's right. I'm calling you out. You're just yet another derivative side interpretation of Son Wukong. I know, and you know. Admit it to yourself, Shiba, because we all know. Sorry, I'm just salty
it's
about
fine.
Shiba.
Scarlet says, Rocket Ship, I downloaded that video.
Oh, it's so good.
And one of the ones I really like for Mark, it's not an animated, but it's the,
his, like, best of compilation from the FNAF series.
No, the song one. Turned,
It's so cool.
The space song.
Yeah.
Yes, the space It's so cool song.
Yeah.
I love
that
one.
That was so good.
I love looking at his face when he's doing that. Because he looks so happy. Like,
and
legitimately
whoever,
just like,
Whoever remixed that did a fantastic job. Because his delivery of, I was going to say those lines, just when he said that, it wasn't timed the way that it comes across in the song. They actually stretched some of the audio and clipped it in a few places so that it fits the meter.
Uh-huh.
And yet it still sounds natural. So they did a great job on it.
But yes, my favorite Markiplier video of all time is the FNAF compilation.
This compilation is so good. Because the editing is so snappy.
It's hilarious. I died the first time. Like, I actually hurt myself laughing so hard the first time we watched that video.
I can't flashlight!
Yep. Scott says, space song! I should make that my ringtone. Grendel says, fun fact, my nickname in high school was Rocket Man.
Oh, good times.
Cool.
That's a cool nickname, actually.
My nickname was Squirrel because I had poopy brown hair.
Have much of one aside from my old screen name.
And then I decided that it was fine that Squirrel was my nickname and I was gonna own it, and then we made Squirrella the Queen of the Squirrels.
That's another topic for another day.
Yeah, that was
a whole
crazy
other can of acorns unto itself.
Yeah. And Squirrella was actually a name that in a high school English class we had to essentially do a short little like play style thing. About one of the Greek myths. And so we had to name the characters. And so my character was named Squirrella. And I think I was supposed to be Persephone. I think that was I forget exactly which myth we were going with. But yeah, because we decided to go with my nickname plus Ella, which is, you know, a female appellation on the end of the name. So it's Squirrella. Which is really hard to say, by the way. Mm. But yeah, so that's where that came from.
Yeah, that 5 months fast.
No. No thanks. But yeah. I really did have poofy brown hair in middle school, which is where the name Squirrel first came from. Then in high school, it did get a little bit less poofy. Not a lot. I'm surprised that you decided I was pretty when we met, considering I was miserably sick and I never do. We're not even gonna look at his face. We're just boot. Grendel says, "All right, almost done with the mask redux. First in-game test now."
Oh no. I didn't know it was happening so soon.
The nightmares are coming.
I hadn't emotionally prepared.
You better do it now. That is just the stupidest.
I forgot about that attack.
That is just the stupidest. The fact that they have a guy doing that.
I know.
In general,
Don't ask about the lizard man growing wings. It's fine. It makes complete and total anatomical sense.
It's normal. Don't worry about it.
Don't even worry about it.
Ow.
Also, he has a name now.
What, him?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it's because, I don't think in some of the other games where Lizard Man was playable that you were actually playing as the same one.
No. This is definitely a unique one. That's why he has wings.
Yeah, this is an individual character.
His tail is so floppy.
Yeah. It does have kind of good physics, though.
It has interesting physics. The problem is it's not heavy enough.
Yeah, it doesn't have enough, like, felt weight in the animations, because it looks like it's just featherweight.
And it's not. It shouldn't be.
No, I mean, a tail like that should have a lot of, like, meat to it.
And I hate watching it, like, I'm like, no. Please stop.
No.
Jack
me in the ribs, why don't you?
It's too bad that the staff isn't better.
Ceratosaurus frill.
Grandma says, I wish there was masculine and feminine variations for each weapon. Some of the coolest weapons are locked behind animations that look hilarious on male characters.
I agree.
And some of them don't look good on, like, male ones don't look good on female characters because they're, like, standing in ways that...
Yeah, like, nightmare style looks ridiculous on a female character model.
Yeah, like, it... Ugh. But no, I agree. I do wish there was some way to, like, an alternate character moveset or something that uses the same type of weapon.
I miss the SoCal 3 days when the custom characters had their own menu of totally unique styles that no named character in the series had.
Yeah.
Because there was, like, a custom katana style, a custom greatsword style.
And the custom katana style was your best style.
It was. I was amazing with it.
Better than Mitsurugi.
Yeah, actually was. There were even a few styles for custom characters that there were no equivalents of in the normal roster. Like there were
the boots
ones? Yeah, like bladed shoes. There was one that was
the
like...
Fans.
Yeah, there were fans.
I liked
There's
the fans.
The dual-wielded reverse blade curved swords.
That
was
one
really
I loved.
Cool style.
I loved that one. Used that for a lot of things.
Like, there were a lot of cool styles that just never showed up again. Oh, there was the dagger and explosives thing.
Oh, yes. That was my favorite.
I had my little inside joke for years about where every time I would throw an explosive, it was just, Hebabum! Hey, son, you look like you would like Hebabum! Hebabum!
Yep. Grandma says, none of you are safe. And there's a link.
Oh, no. Oh, God! It's even worse! I look like the dude!
It's the
it's the big Kinbowski. Oh God, the eyes. It actually sort of reminds me of, oh man, I haven't seen it in so long. I don't remember the name. One of the characters from The Watchmen. Oh jeez. With
and
the
Scarlet,
smiley face.
And Scarlet asks, please post these to Discord.
Oh yeah, please.
The eyes are like.
It really reminds me of the Watchmen guy. Not in a good way. Grendel, what have you done? You're a madman.
I'm gonna close it now. I'm just gonna, for my own sanity, just gonna not anymore.
Oh, man. I should save some of those images, cut them out as PNGs, and put them on the face of the character model in Turbo Dismount.
And Grendel says, the comedian?
Yeah, there we go. My little, like, face cutout PNGs that I used for Turbo Dismount the first time.
Oh, they're so bad now.
They're so old. They're from, like, year one.
Yeah. We need to find better pictures so I can cut them out and gif and hand them to you.
I've actually got a lot of good stills. I've actually saved some as I was taking screenshots to make thumbnails out of.
Mm-hmm.
I've got a folder of stuff that I was just like, oh, that's actually a good headshot of me. So that I can actually crop some of them and use them for like acting gig applications, because some of them want headshots.
Mm-hmm.
If it's like for appearing on a YouTube video for some company's product or something.
Yeah.
So I'm actually saving some of those.
I'll hand me a good one and I'll cut your face out and we can plop it on Turbo Deuce Matt.
I did actually return the message, speaking of acting gigs, to the Metro guy. I still gotta check and see if he got
back to you yet.
Because he gave me a list of characters that still needed voices, and so we're gonna start hashing out which one I'm gonna voice. So
I'm so excited!
Yeah.
I'm so excited! Oh my gosh.
And I asked him directly, so I can actually get a clear answer. Whether or not the Artyom from the Metro mod is supposed to represent the same Artyom as from the Metro games. I assume it does.
Or is it just somebody who's...
Yeah, just someone else with that name. Because that is a somewhat common name in Slavic countries, so...
That's probably why they chose it.
Probably, yeah.
Because it's kind of like John.
Yeah, it's like a Slavic version of an everyman name, which was kind of the idea.
Oh, God.
Ow, damn it!
Oh, and you had just the barest sliver.
No. I'm not super great with this style, so I didn't really figure I'd pull
which
that
is,
off.
Which is sad, because if this was your actual, like,
if this was just
Pathfinder,
Killik style.
If this was just Killik style, you would kick butt.
Like, I could massacre with Killik style. They really made large changes from Killik to Shiba, though.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, if this was actually, like, Corbin himself accurately represented,
oh.
Poor Aeon would not have a good day.
No.
Because that man... is a madman with a heavy crossbow, a spear, and a longsword, all of which he's ready to ruin your day with.
Yup. Saved says, I'm out. Gotta get up early tomorrow, like always. Adulting is annoying.
It is, man.
We get you.
It so is.
I feel ya.
It's overrated.
It is overrated. Kids, like, want to be an adult. I'm like, no. No.
Like
you
every...
want to be a kid, I promise you.
Every year... I internalize more and more this realization that I had when I was like...
I am that.
Well, no, like, when I was about 25, it hit me real hard that there really isn't much of such a thing as an adult, really. We're all still the kids that we once were, just sidled with more responsibility.
And trying to pretend that everything is okay.
The expectation of just playing along and figuring it out along the way. We're all just winging it. You know those 50-year-olds that you think have life figured out? No, they don't. They've just winged it for 50 years, and they're starting to get pretty good at it. That's all.
Mm-hmm. Kids, stay kids.
Yeah.
Enjoy it.
Do not kill your inner child. You'll miss him.
Enjoy it while you can. Adulting is so overrated.
Like, the one thing, like, adulting-wise that I do miss, and that one day we shall have again, is the autonomy.
Yeah.
Because right now we are still dependent on family for support. Because as supportive as you guys are, which I can never thank any of you enough for,
Thank you.
There aren't enough of you to support us financially on our own 2 feet yet, so family is helping to do that until we get there. Which, again, like, I can never thank all of the involved parties for everything they've done. I do miss, though, just the ability, and this is maybe the most adult thing I've ever said or felt, because I really do honestly feel it, I miss the ability to pay my own bills. God, I wish I could do that again. Because once upon a time I could, when I was working a job I hated.
Saved says, yep, so agree.
Mm.
And I could pay it when I was working a job that I didn't really enjoy.
Mm.
And then going through serious health crises and then super depression.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it didn't stay.
Life, man. It happens.
And then I probably would have gotten laid off.
Yeah, because they let go of a lot of people.
They let go of a lot of people. Well, because they thought there was a merger coming that ended up falling through. So they were getting rid of a lot of the extraneous staff that they wouldn't need.
Yeah.
You know, and I was brand new, basically.
Yeah, I mean, you know, the...
No corporate tenure, as it were.
Yeah, last in the door is the first to go. So.
Yeah. So I know I would have gotten laid off, most likely.
Enough of this style's quick moves to get in on him before his stuff connects on me.
Yeah. I believe in you?
No, I'll get it. It's just, I gotta...
Gotta work for it a little harder than usual.
I must concentrate.
Man, this stream has gone so many different ways.
We've covered some conversational ground today.
Oh, yeah. I gotcha. Never did give the list of my favorite Final Fantasies in order. I'm gonna commit heresy for myself.
Uh-oh.
My favorite Final Fantasy.
Dare I know what's coming?
Is FF15.
Yeah, I thought so.
Followed by FF7. Very closely followed, but like...
It has now. You've said it on camera. Official now.
It is official.
It has overtaken it.
It has. Probably not, like... When the remake comes out, I'm sure it will reclaim its former position.
I hope so. Man, I want to love it.
I want to love it so much. I want it so bad. You would not believe the sound that came out of my mouth when Kin showed me the video for the...
Because the first time they dropped a teaser for it, she had already gone to sleep, so I was alone in the office.
And the thing is I was hearing the da-da
sound
and
soundtrack.
Through the wall. And I was like, oh, he must be listening to Pandora.
Yeah.
And I thought nothing of it and went and started sinking a little bit further into sleep. And then, like, 5 minutes later, he bursts into the bedroom. You have to get up. You have to see this. And I'm like, I was almost deeply, I was so close. And I'm like, what? And he's like, you have to see this. You must see this. And I'm like, okay, get up. And he, shows me the video that someone had recorded from
at E3,
the Square Enix thing, and I'm like, cool, Square Enix, I like Square Enix, and then the music starts up, and I'm like,
wait.
I'm like, no, this can't be, this isn't, and then it keeps going, and I'm like, oh my god,
no.
Oh my god, it is it happening, is it, and then at the very, very end, when it goes, Final Fantasy VII Remake. I lost my shit. Like, I went insane.
The promise has been made. I was like, yes!
I made the strangest, most high-pitched, squeaky, squealy, squee noise I have ever made in my life. Like, I couldn't replicate it if I tried. And then I didn't go to sleep for like 3 hours after that because I was too excited. but I want to love that game, and if it sticks to what they've teased, I think I will.
I think it'll end up good as long as they don't ruin it with shady corporate stuff.
Yes. So I and especially with the Windows edition of 15 and all that sort of stuff made me even more hopeful.
Yeah.
For the remake of 7.
And Nomura's involvement at such a chief level of it gives me some hope.
Yeah, so I do feel hopeful for it.
Yeah.
So I expect when it comes out, and if it's as good as I hope it will be, even with my tentative hopes for it, 7 will probably retake its spot as number one. For now, it's 15, followed extraordinarily closely by 7, followed... by Final Fantasy Brave Exvius. Followed by Final Fantasy X. Which is followed by Final Fantasy XII and then Final Fantasy VIII. Wait, no, that's incorrect. Okay, so 15, 7, Brave Exvius, 10, Duodecim, 12,
and fair, 8. Yeah.
There we go. That's my proper.
I adore the story of FF12. I just think it was told in the worst
possible
order.
I love the world and the actual story of 12.
Yeah. And it gets deep the more you dig into it.
Yeah. Like, we have, what, two or is it three now?
I've got three different theory videos
for the world of Ivalice, which is the world of FF12.
Yeah,
as well as FF Tactics and Tactics Advance.
Yes. Tactics Advance A2.
A2.
Because Tactics Advance 1 is in Dream Ivalice, so it's
okay, so it's not official. Right. Grendel says, want me to send y'all an official LLP brand Kin mask for Fallout 4?
God.
We'll get it on the Creation Club and get some real Bethesda bucks. I don't think we'll get it on Creation Club. But sure, send us the Kin mask.
If you send it to me,
he'll do a mod spotlight for
it. I'll add a little, like, 10-second mod spotlight for it to the end of another mod spotlight. Like a mod spotlight shout out.
Spotlightception.
Yeah.
Sorry, I didn't catch all. I really do think he might be partially deaf.
Maybe.
Like, because we don't know anything about him or Viola.
We really don't.
I still think
Viola's Amy.
Yeah, I kept expecting for
the revelation to come. Yeah.
Like, I kept expecting it to tell us who these people are.
And it just never does. In 4 or 5, they're just here.
Like, they just exist. Like, it...
Is it Vi?
Scott says, is this dude using a cane sword?
He is.
Mm-hmm.
Is this my Plague Doc character?
Cane sword.
Yeah.
Can you make...
Yeah.
Can you make both of them?
Maybe.
Because we have two slots.
Whoa. Ow. Just an actual normal longsword, there actually isn't really a good form for in this game. The closest thing is actually Mitsurugi with the Euro-style sword skin. Like, that's the closest you can actually get in this game to just having a normal longsword. Because Lex Vi's weapon is
one. Well, we can rapier.
Yeah, we could rapier.
Because she knows how to rapier.
That's true.
She's honor dueled before.
That's true.
She just prefers the utilitarian isms of the longsword.
Yeah.
We can go court version of her.
That's true. Like, formal attire.
Uh-huh.
We're discussing converting one of her recent tabletop characters into a soul.
What would we name them?
Put placeholders in.
Yeah, we'll put placeholders in until we actually officially name them.
Yeah. Shank. I do intentionally go for that last little downward stab right there at the Achilles. I love that little skull thing on the top of his staff. It actually looks really cool.
Mm-hmm. Scott says, KO with a kick to the balls. Ouch. And I actually really like Hilda's armor here.
Yeah,
it's the most realistic of all of the armors in this entire game series.
100%. She's still got a little boob plate going on. Not much, though.
No.
The rest of her armor is actually pretty serviceable.
And honestly, if she's actually a fairly large-chested lady...
You still wouldn't want the dip in the middle.
No, you wouldn't want the dip in the middle, but the...
Oh, yeah, the outward curve.
The
yeah.
outward curve. Because you don't want to squish those too much. That's very uncomfortable.
Actual, like, Spanish breastplates, they're actually outwardly curved anyway.
Uh-huh.
And it's meant so that... impacts just sort of glance off a curved edge.
Yeah.
And don't have.
It's just the dip in the middle that you don't want.
Yeah, because all that does is just guide an edge right into the center and to a weak point in the armor so that it would probably pierce more likely than if it weren't there.
Mm-hmm.
Which is why that center divot in the usual.
Yeah,
anime
and as far as a girl goes,
she's
her
covered
heels.
Up.
She doesn't have high heels!
Yeah, she actually has, like, cavalry heels, because, fun fact, for anyone that doesn't know...
That's why heels are a thing.
Yeah, that's the reason that heels on footwear exist.
Was
is
so they could fit onto the...
The stirrups of a horse.
The stirrups. And so you could get a better, like, grip
mm-hmm.
with it. Because the stirrups could hook into where the heel is.
Mm-hmm. That is why heels exist on footwear.
And
high heels were once a male fashion accessory.
Mm-hmm. Grendel says, haha, I can never release it, unfortunately. It's a retexture of a piece from the headpiece dispatcher. and the author didn't give permission for assets.
Ah, dang. I appreciate the thought anyway.
Yeah. Grendel says, I dislike that one of the only actual chest plates available for character creation has boob plates on the male model.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and set.
That's one of the things that I don't like. I know it's common in a lot of fantasy. The usually it's a bronze chest plate from like a Greco-Roman style that has like the contoured pecs and abs. God, I hate that so much.
Scott says she also has spurs and gonna go do the jingle jangle jingle jingle jangle.
She got spurs.
That's because she's actually a cavalryman.
Yep.
And that's what the spear's actually for. Yeah, it's a lance. It's a lance. It's meant for her being on horseback. Mm-hmm. Her style on foot makes no sense, but her design makes a lot of sense. Because she has her cavalry sword, but she also has her lance. She has the boots with the heels and the spurs, because
with
war
the
horse... And the only skirt she has is, like, this side skirt that wouldn't hamper her from sitting on a horse.
Yep.
Full armor. Helmet. She actually makes a lot of sense.
Mm-hmm.
I just wish there was a way to keep the full armor for her and take off the helmet.
Yeah, same.
But that's not
a
thing.
More sense than Sophia ever did.
Uh-huh. It says, I just saw a medieval nobleman getting around in stilettos.
Once upon a time, it was high fashion, man.
Yeah, to have high heels for the guys.
For guys, yeah. I don't know exactly. I think it was in the Victorian era when it sort of shifted genders who high heels were cool for.
Yeah.
There's actually quite a lot now that is considered female fashion that started as courtly male fashion in Western Europe. I'm sure there's some sort of, like, social thing to extrapolate out of that. I don't know. I only took a few sociology courses. I'm not qualified to get into that.
Mm-mm. I don't even know why the fashion started in the first place, for example.
Yeah, I know! Ching.
Sarah says, and suddenly Bane is here.
Yeah, pretty much.
Gendel says, even the Astaroth is different. Bah. Well, technically it's a clone of Astaroth or some such, but still.
Yeah.
This one is the real Astaroth.
Yeah, this is the real Astaroth. The things in the tanks are clones of him. This is the real one, though.
Yeah.
See ya.
His style also looks stupid on ladies.
Looks stupid on anyone that isn't a giant like him.
Mm-hmm. Like on any of the created characters, you cannot make someone big enough to make it not look stupid.
Yeah. Like you have to just put them in like super huge armor to try and give the illusion that
like you have to make them as tall and as buff as you possibly can, and then you put them in the super big armor.
Yeah.
Just to try and
Because otherwise it just looks ridiculous.
Mm-hmm. That sounds creepy.
It does.
I'm not sure I'm okay with that.
I'm kind of sad no one's actually destroyed my armor yet.
Ow. That's the thing, is Alpha Patroclus
is one of my stronger styles.
Is really good.
Ow. Ow.
Ooh. Well, you might get your wish.
Yeah, this guy might do it. I got a little goofy with the under armor for this guy.
Just because you could?
Yeah, pretty much.
Because he's not really based on anyone.
Nah, he's just someone I threw together because the parts were there, and I was just like, I could make a plague doctor out of these. Really, it was as soon as I saw this like Alucard style hat and the plague doc mask, I was like, I'm gonna make one.
Yep, that's what happened. I still wish I knew who Kia was, because I like her design enough that I feel like she should be someone. She even has a name. And I have characters that I'm playing that
years
don't
old
have names.
Characters that don't have names yet.
It's semi-upsetting. It's because I didn't care. Like, we just threw together a name for her. Just random. And that's,
Yeah.
Calibur 3 Astaroth with the giant fucking claw hammer mask.
Same. Of course, I still miss the design for SoCal 2 Nightmare. Mm-hmm. And I think so does the SoCal team, because that's the version of him that they still use on their official logo.
Yeah. Well, so much for the breaking of the armor.
Yeah.
Question. Is that the one that they're going with for the new SoCal?
I don't know.
Because I don't remember.
I don't remember if they've shown off what Nightmare is like in the new one yet. Because I know they've shown Mitsurugi, Sophitia, Geralt.
Did they show Siegfried?
I don't think they showed Siegfried.
I miss his headbang. I'm sorry.
I also miss his cool, like, red tabard outfit from, I think, 3?
Mm-hmm.
I just thought it looked really cool. And, like, this version of Nightmare is closer to the old SC2 version.
But not, it's still not quite.
Yeah, it's still not quite there, though. Owie! 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 Could you not?
You want to know something I just realized that I find kind of amusing?
Huh.
Nightmare is a female name. Because a mare is a female horse. And a nightmare is a demon horse that causes night terrors.
That is true.
So a nightmare is a demon, a female demon horse.
Hadn't put that together. You're not wrong, though. You hear that, Nightmare? She's questioning your manhood here, man. You gonna take that?
Yep. Gendel says, he was always so goofy. He's been everything from a gimp with hilarious hair to a lava monster to a blue guy with a cockroach mask.
Yep.
And Soul Calibur 2 Nightmare is best Nightmare. Best Soul Edge, too.
Yeah, I agree.
Yep.
It was so simple.
Oh, there's
there we go!
I forgot you gave him the...
Yalgol hair.
I 100% forgot. So the hat gets rid of the braids.
Yeah. And you know who I miss? Because she hasn't appeared in several games in a row now. Friggin' Song Mina!
Yeah.
God! Once upon a time, she was one of my strongest characters. And she's just friggin' MIA.
Scott says, could you make actual Alucard in this? We already did.
I did.
We already did.
I'll show you if y'all want. Well, that's just not very neighborly.
Nope. You're a bad neighbor.
Bunk. Funkle, get whumped. Alright, I'm going to actually concentrate instead of halfway thinking about going
to says, it was like a cleaver with a bunch of meat and an eyeball. It was great. Even the 2P version with all the teeth was cool.
It was.
The teeth one creeped me out.
Yeah. Well, they reused,
I liked it, but
some of the
it
ideas
creeped
for
me
that,
out.
For the sword in, I don't know which one it was. One of the ones where there's like the super uber monster version of Nightmare with like the wings and everything. And it was like a giant 2P version of it. It looked super creepy and really cool. Ow. Shit, man. I don't know if I can actually do this without the trope. This. Shit.
He's so cheap.
Like, I'm really rusty with Alpha Patroclus.
Mm-hmm. He used to be one of your best ones, but he's a very complicated character.
He is. Like, he's very involved, and if you don't have the commands committed to memory, then you can't really make the most.
Grandel says Night Terror.
Yes, yep. Night Terror. That thing was so cool. Really, really freaking nuts hard.
I think Nightmare should have been called Night Terror.
Yeah.
Because it is a female horse. He is named after a demon female horse. How does that make you feel?
Yeah, hear that, Night? Oh god. No, no, no. Eat anime. Oh crap. I was gonna go full I have the power of anime and god on my side, and then he just decided, no you don't.
Just no.
Well, that worked appropriately. Alright, hang on. Since one of y'all asked
about Alucard.
Character select.
Grandel says, I miss that guy with the owl mask. I don't even remember his name.
Ulkadan.
Swaggering.
Yes. Let's see. Create a character. Alucard, where are you? Oh, you know.
There he is.
I'm actually really happy with how he came together in this game.
need to get some goddamn DSL up in here.
Do you know who I miss?
Hmm? Wait, Zasa's in this game, I thought. Or is he not?
I don't think so.
Is he not?
Maybe he was, and I just don't remember it, because he didn't, like...
I don't remember. I'll check.
Yeah, Scar says Nightmare equals Fear Pony. Yeah, basically.
Pretty much.
Oh, and you gave him the anime.
Yeah, I had to. You gotta.
Yeah, I had to give him the Devil Jin style, because there's not a gun style, so I had to go unarmed.
Grendel says, isn't there some hilarious MLP fan art version of Nightmare somewhere? I am now intrigued.
Someone has to have made it.
Well, I can't be the only one who thinks Nightmare equals, you know, demon
at this point,
night terror dream pony.
We need, like, a rule 34.5.
For
not the,
the pony version.
Yeah, if you can think it, there is porn of it. There's now also, if you can think it, there is pony of it. Like... The
well,
art
there,
is so
there,
prolific.
There is a rule for, gender switching.
Yeah, that's... I don't remember the number.
I don't remember
the
number. So, this is, like, a weird addendum between the two. Scarlet's looking for it. Grendel says, if not, I'll make it.
If anyone can find it, I know it's Scarlet. He is our resident brony here.
I am sure if it exists, he will find it for us.
I'm actually super proud of how some of my replica characters
Leisha.
Yeah, there we go.
She's so 2000s Japanese.
No.
Schoolgirl.
And it saddens me
because
that she is Zhonghua's daughter, just not from Helic.
That makes me upset. That upset me, and I wasn't that invested.
Yeah, Zhonghua just married some general guy that we don't even know the name of.
I prefer Zhonghua's ending in the other game.
Yeah.
Like, where she went off with Keelik.
Mm-hmm.
And the two of them are together. Like,
they
I think they should have been. Because they were happy. And instead, she had to settle.
You hear that, Leisha? You're the result of Zhonghua settling. You are not the product of a happy marriage, just a content one.
That's why she left. Because she could tell.
Yeah.
Mom resents my existence.
You're goddamn right, and so do I.
Also, your outfit makes no sense. It doesn't work unless you have double-sided tape from the 21st century.
Your outfit is bad, and you should feel bad.
Sorry, we have some feelings.
I don't like that, John. Have I made that clear?
Also, I don't understand how that, like, without zippers, that outfit doesn't work because there's no tie. Like, how does she get it on?
Your poofy pants make your ass look fat!
They don't. Really. Because they're see-through, so you can see the actual shape.
Still, it confuses the lines.
Her donk
high looks
fashion.
Saggy.
It's the high fashion thing, I guess.
That's probably one of the weirdest sentences I've ever said. It makes her donk look saggy.
Yeah, also, which was the one that I really liked the Ivy outfit in?
I don't remember.
Might have been 3.
I think it was one of her alts in one of the older ones.
Yeah, because I haven't liked it in the last 2 games.
Ivy's primary outfits always look stupid, if I'm honest. Her alts look awesome a lot of the time, though. It's like you can tell that's where they let one of the other character designers, like, put in cool designs.
Mm-hmm.
No, we have to make her look skimpy for the iconic.
Oh,
we can put in
Scarlet
other stuff
has,
oh, God.
There's a tier of Soul Calibur pony.
It's out there.
Oh, there's a...
That's Pyrrha.
That's Omega Pyrrha.
Yeah.
Derp everything.
Weirdly, that's actually really well done.
Uh-huh. Grendel says, it doesn't come off. It was made around her, and she'll never take it off. She doesn't even bathe. And Scarlet says, you're welcome. I like the Omega Pyrrha one. The eyes on her flank are really creepy.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, as her symbol thing. That one is actually really well done, though.
incredible. How'd she do that?
Ivy is magic, didn't you know?
I mean, yeah, she is actually, like, in lore an alchemist. Hey, I didn't guard that there.
Lasers.
Oh, here's a...
Straight through your skull.
Somebody's created character.
People get crazy creative in the customization system for this game. Like, somebody made a really, like, highly detailed... I don't know how they did
it. Oh, wait, no. This is some... I think this was a pony that actually exists, and they made a human version.
Oh, a SoulCal extrapolation?
Yeah. I think that's what this is. Symbol thing is called the cutie mark, even on stallions. It's a scarlet.
Yeah.
Wow.
Somebody made...
Oh, yeah, they did. They've made SoulCal versions, extrapolations of some of the characters.
Yeah, a super detailed version of Dart from Legend of Dragoon, like, complete with his wings and everything from the full Dragoon mode thing.
That's really cool.
And I have no idea how, because it looks like it's using more slots for the, like, custom items that you can just attach to their character model
than
you usually have.
And yet
the screenshot is there, so clearly they did it somehow.
Yeah, Grandal says, isn't Ivy's backstory, like, obscenely dark?
It really is!
Yeah, pretty much.
Like, her dad died, and she put, like, her own soul in a sword, and then her dad, Cervantes, is, like, the Dread Pirate Cervantes. His soul is consumed in the sword, and she goes and hunts him down and frees him, and yet he hates her because the sword has consumed him and his morals, and... She hates herself for what she is and more so what she isn't. And all, like, yeah, Ivy has a convoluted and really dark and depressing story.
She's the reason SoulCal exists, though.
She is.
But yes, her backstory. Whew. Her story in general.
Oh, yeah. I mean, she's the iconic character for the whole franchise. Like, she is, as you said, the reason the Soul Calibur as a series exists. Ow. Womp! Oh crap, I didn't womp him. There we go. Elbow.
You womped him this time. It's fine. I did like, was it 3? Where her sword shattered to save her?
Yes!
And freed her soul from the tainted soul edge?
God, I loved that so much. I don't know if it's canon, though.
I don't think it's canon. I want it to be, though.
Because that would have actually concluded her story in a light and hopeful way. And Ivy deserves that. She's suffered so much.
And here's the last one.
Jeez, what? That's adorably aggressive. I can have soul moms now.
I can have soul moms now. Thank you, Scarlet, for finding the SoulCal pony.
I knew it was out there somewhere. It had to be.
I mean, there's not a specifically nightmare one.
Yeah,
that he found.
Close enough.
But Omega Pira is pretty dang close. Yeah. That was a really good Omega Pira pony edition.
No. Dang it! I had just started an attack animation. I couldn't guard. No. Denied. My turn. Get womped on! My ult is cooler than yours. Ow.
Well, yeah,
ow.
He's number 2, and his wolf moon monster Eidolon thing is number 1.
Yep.
How does that make you feel, Zvi?
Your second fiddle to your sidekick. How does that even work?
Daniel says, wait, her backstory is even darker. She's a product of rape.
Wait, is
Cervantes
she?
Impregnated so Solage could have a spare host.
Holy shit, I didn't know that. That's creepy.
Yeah. Did not know that.
Funk. Then again, quite a few of the characters in this game have, well, the series at least, have really dark stories.
As far as this game goes, I actually kind of feel bad for Pyrrha and Patroclus.
Oh, yeah, because they were getting used the whole time. Yeah.
And there was nothing they could have done about it.
I mean,
they grew up that way.
Yeah. The one story thing I will cut this game some credit for is it did shed itself of the shackles of the convention of good versus evil. and really frames it more as law versus chaos.
Yeah.
Which are not necessarily either good or evil inherently. Mm-hmm. They're just diametrically opposed.
Yeah. And Soul Calibur, you need to...
Soul Calibur is not good.
Oh, no.
Neither is Soul Edge. I'm just saying. Soul Calibur is not a paladin the sword.
No. So it says that double forward back face kick is awesome. Now that was a literal ass kicking. Yep. But yeah, I feel bad for Kira and Patroclus.
Yeah.
They never had a chance.
They were just getting played in a cosmic chess match that's way above their pay grade. The battle rages on.
Stand battle to fight. Whoop. Whoop them. And neither of them exactly get out fine in the end.
No, they really don't.
They will be screwed up for the rest of their lives, however long that is, which I don't know.
Suspect is very long.
It'll either be really short, or it'll be really, really long, depending on what
their powers have made them immortal.
Yeah, like, because that would suck. But,
oh yeah, I forgot. They also showed off footage of a new character for the new Soul Cal that I am convinced is Patroclus just in a disguise. Like, he's going full Saiyaman mode.
Oh, yeah?
It's some dude with, like, a double-ended sword that, for one, looks really modern in his mode of dress and style. Like, he looks like something Tetsuya Nomura would have designed.
Huh.
And his face, and even just the rapidity of his movements, like, how nimble and agile he is, it really reminds me of Patroclus. So, like, I'm calling it way early.
That is Patroclus,
that's
somehow.
That's Patroclus in disguise.
In the past?
Yeah. And maybe this isn't a prequel, and it is some sort of time warp thing, and Patroclus traveled into the past to try and change things. Like, I don't know.
So his mom doesn't die, and his sister doesn't get kidnapped, and then...
Yeah, I don't know. It's just... It really looks like... Or maybe it's Patroclus' dad or something.
Because we never know who that is.
No, we don't.
Grendel says, Siegfried killed his own father, and his whole reason for trying to find Soul Edge in the first place...
It's because he was Nightmare.
Because he deluded himself into believing somebody else killed his father, and only who wielded Soul Edge could be strong enough to do that.
Yep.
Seriously, Nightmare in this game is Raphael, I'm sure of it. He's not.
No, not in this game.
Not in this
Raphael
game.
Raphael was...
We do actually find out who Nightmare is in this game.
And it's some weird, like, NPC corrupt noble guy that doesn't actually have any bearing on the story.
No.
Which I thought was a weird
choice.
The
only thing that he has bearing on is that he's been using Patroclus.
Yeah. That's it, though. Like, it's just some dude that we've never heard of, we'll never hear of again.
Mm-hmm.
And that's
it. And Raphael is in this game.
Oh, yeah, he is.
He's just not important.
No, not really.
And, like, I don't think he actually shows up
in
the
main. I think he does for a short little while.
Like, a singular fight.
He doesn't really do much, though.
But, yeah, this is just some corrupt noble dude.
Yeah, like, I miss the days of when Raphael had just left France.
Yeah.
And then went to Romania and went full Dracula mode with Amy.
Yeah.
And then the corruption that was already seeded into him affected the surrounding countryside to the point where... The citizenry rose up with flaming torch mobs against his castle. Like, it was so damn cool!
Yeah, Grendel says,
we're just not doing that
but
anymore.
Look at his model. Go into character customization and look at his model. Raphael isn't featured in the main story either.
Is he not?
I thought he had, like, maybe one fight
I thought he appeared really
against him.
Shortly.
But no, this...
No, like, in the story mode, it does tell you who
exact,
Nightmare is in
it. Like,
game.
It says his actual name.
Yeah, like, by name. It's just some dude. Some lord that Patroclus had trusted. And shouldn't have, clearly. It's not
and
Raphael.
He wasn't named Raphael.
No. It's some other guy.
I mean, I suppose you could make the argument that maybe it was Raphael in disguise as the noble, but he doesn't seem like the sort of person that would not use his own name.
No. Nor do I think, as crazy as he is, that... the Soul
yeah,
Calibur
entity...
Yeah,
and Grendel says pseudonym!
I don't quite give that a whole lot of credence. Like, maybe
and he
I'd
also,
have to look at it again.
Also, if he got Soul Edge, it wouldn't take the form of a giant Soul Edge.
No.
Like, because Raphael's never used a giant sword, has he?
And I don't see it totally overwriting his personality the way that it did with this other guy.
No. Because by the time this guy gets Soul Edge, he becomes Nightmare. He's not even him anymore.
Yeah, exactly.
No!
And I don't really see it in his model.
Nah.
I mean, maybe we do need to go to character customization to get a better look at the model, but I don't really see it.
Look at it. I just don't have time.
It says either their art design is really lazy or it's Raphael. It's his face under the helmet when you customize it.
Wait, what? Okay,
it's
that I'll have to look at.
It's probably really lazy because it's this game and they couldn't even put in enough cutscenes or put in enough storyboards to cover the missing scenes where, like, somebody falls off a freaking bridge.
Yeah, and some of the character models, like, of these NPCs in the distance are actually imported models from SoulCal 3 and 4. Like, they didn't even make new assets for the stuff going on in the set pieces.
Yeah, so I would...
They cut a lot of corners.
I would bet money that it's,
Hang on. I am curious, though. I want to see this. Yeah. I need to hit the restroom, though, so I'm going to leave chat in your capable care for a moment.
Okay. Hurry up.
And again, apologies for shifty noises, because sensitive mic, and we're set up on a couch.
Uh-huh. Which the mic is sort of kind of sitting on. But yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if they cut a lot of corners and used the same models. But there is a Raphael in this game, whether he was in the story mode or not. So we can compare it. So we'll take a look. But I wouldn't be surprised if they didn't expect anyone to really take off his helmet. Because I don't think even if you break his armor that the helmet comes off for Nightmare. I don't remember for sure, but... So I could see them easily just being like, oh, just put one of the other characters underneath it, because all we care about is the armor. But we shall see. We shall see. We will get to the bottom of this. Okay. It's his face in that art too, though. We'll have to look at it. They might have just used him as a basis, as, like, kind of creepy nobleman. But we'll definitely take a look, for sure. Just gotta wait for Kin to return.
I am of return!
Grendel did say that it's his face in the art too, not just the Nightmare.
Wait, what art piece shows his face under the
I don't know. We'll have to look. I didn't think that any of the art for Nightmare specifically had his face showing.
I didn't think it did.
It might have been, like I said, if it was the storyboards, which I really do think they just ran out of time and or money.
Yeah,
To make actual things with it. But they might have just used Raphael as a kind of creepy nobleman base.
Really customized, yeah.
And then here's the...
Oh my god, that is Raphael.
Yeah, it is. They used Raphael. Yeah, there's the... That's the storyboard, though. I don't trust the storyboard.
That is the storyboard, except this is the character model. Hang on, That's him.
Yeah.
Like, actually him.
It's really
weird.
I don't know. That seems really strange, because I don't get why...
I could actually change his hair. I can't change almost anything else.
I don't get why they would have it be Raphael and not just have it be Raphael.
Persona of Deceit.
That's the mask.
Well, yeah. I think that's a hint, though.
Yeah. I don't understand why they would have it be Raphael but not have it be actually, like, him named. I feel like this is the part that got scrapped somewhere in development.
Yeah.
Because I mean, this, Vi and Viola.
Yeah. Still, though, I mean, like, the evidence is kind of staring us in the face, yeah. Literally.
Well, no, I mean, like, I think that this story concept.
Yeah, of, like, doing something with this.
Yeah, of making him Raphael.
Yeah.
I think that got scrapped sometime in development, and they just never got rid of it because they, I mean, obviously, they didn't have enough time to put the storyboards in for the missing scenes.
Yeah.
Or to animate the scenes. Yeah, like
they cut so many freaking corners on this
game. So I wouldn't be surprised if there was supposed to be more to do with Raphael and Viola and Zvi, and they just never did it.
Yeah.
But the leftovers, basically, of that are here, kind of the way in 15, the leftovers of Etro.
Yeah.
Are kind of there, too.
That's possible.
Grendel says they bothered to model a mask, but not the rest of his face. Like I said, I bet this is an early development thing that they left in. Probably as a Easter egg.
Yeah, like, the thing is, I take this approach with extrapolations of games.
Like, we have to assume that it's on purpose.
Yeah.
I get that.
It's in here. So
I get that.
Regardless of whether they addressed it directly or not,
yeah,
it's here.
It doesn't make sense to me. That's the, like, as the character stuff.
Does the rest of this damn story make sense?
Like, well, no, and that's part of the problem.
Oh, and the mask stays on if you put other helmets on
which
it.
Which is weird.
It clips into the forehead clips even.
That is so sad. Like, I think you're right. I think this was going to... I think this was supposed to be Raphael, or was going to be Raphael. I just don't know why.
Or maybe they meant... for it to not come
or maybe,
super obviously. And...
Or maybe it's meant to be kind of a purged version of him. Like, two separate Raphaels.
No, I don't think so.
No?
I don't think that's a thing. Because that's never happened with anyone else.
No. But then none of the others have been vampires either.
Well, they never came out and said he was a vampire either.
They didn't have to.
No, they didn't, however.
In this game, I think they actually... reference that though
jokingly. Yeah, they never come out and say though that he's a straight up supernatural vampire.
That's true. Ghost says good night all, time to crash.
Alrighty.
Good night,
have a good one, man. That's wild though.
Does
I
he
never
talk
knew that.
Like it, like,
good question.
I feel like in the like in the story mode, like early on, there were some scenes where he actually spoke, I thought, like the nobleman dude prior to becoming Nightmare.
I don't know.
And if he did speak, were his...
Yeah, like, was it...
Was Raphael's his voice actor? Raphael's actor? Because I think that would tell us if it's actually Raphael or if it's someone else. Or something else.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. That is interesting. I had no idea that was a thing. Hang on, I'm curious. Let me check something real quick. Okay, exit that. Regular character.
And there's actual.
Raphael. Free edit. I want to see if that mask is available for Raphael.
And his eyes are, of course, red.
Yeah. That's definitely his face, though.
Yeah.
Like, 100%. Completely his dead friggin' lips. Yeah, that mask is unique to the Nightmare version of that model.
Mm-hmm.
It's just part of his face, because it's not here.
Yeah.
Interesting. Hang on, let me look up on
weird,
my phone real quick.
Weird that they would put him in as a character if he was going to be, like, the big bad? Or, well, I guess not the big bad, but, like, if he was going to be Nightmare, that they would put in a Raphael character.
Yeah, that is...
I wonder what the idea was. Because clearly they had some idea here. Because, I mean, Viola and Zvi are very unique in appearance. And the whole Amy thing, which I'm pretty sure Viola is Amy.
Yeah.
But she doesn't remember who she is. Maybe Raphael doesn't remember who he is.
Hang on. Okay. The Nightmare, according to the Soul Calibur 5 wiki, or just the Soul Calibur wiki regarding Soul Cal 5, The Nightmare appearing in Soul Calibur 5, Soul Calibur Lost Swords, and Soul Calibur Unbreakable Soul is a new being, Soul Edge possessing the body of a swordsman, according to the art book Raphael Sorrel, alright, so that's a point in your favor, and plotting behind the scenes under the alias Graf Dumas, as he plans to resurrect the full power of Soul Edge. So alright, according to the wiki...
It's Raphael, but it's also not Raphael, so we were both right.
Well, like, it's a possessed Raphael that isn't him anymore.
It's a possessed body.
Yeah.
Is what it says.
Well, it's the same way that Siegfried was Nightmare, where, yeah. like, it's Siegfried, except not him acting under his own volition anymore. Yeah. Interesting.
But why is Raphael, actual Raphael, in the game?
I don't know. Hang on, let me look up Raphael's thing.
Oh, and they did say, here's the thing for the voice. He sent
Oh, is there a clip for it?
Yeah, he sent
cool.
a clip.
This turned into a friggin' SoCal theory stream all of a sudden. Okay. Oh, that's the cutscene. Okay.
Stand aside. So you're that rampaging murderer.
Oh, that's Vi.
I don't know when...
Who are you calling a
Also, I know Patroclus' voice actor. Where have I heard that?
Some kind of a monster.
Here we go.
Zvi. Damn that cursed werewolf. You know of him, my lord. Is he a Malfested? That man stands in the way of ridding the world of the Malfested. Get rid of him. He seems
Can't
to know
tell.
About my sister. My lord, does he have something to do with her? You just need to kill those I say to kill. I have served you faithfully and done everything you've asked. Yet you have made no effort to search for my sister. It seems you are unable to obey my orders. I've had enough. Leave my sight at once
That's
and never
him.
Return.
It's weird, though, because the voice actor keeps switching accents.
He does,
like, there's,
yeah.
like, five different accents
yeah,
in that one scene.
He's dipping in and out of, like, French and Slavic.
Yeah. And, like, he goes from smooth to gravelly.
Yeah. There were a few words in there, though, where the Raphael intonation crept out. That's the same guy.
And no, the link didn't include the timestamp. Okay, that's...
Ooh, I wonder. Hang on. Let me confirm this, like, 100%, at least as far as the actor.
We can look it up.
I can look up on IMDb who voiced him.
Yes. Yeah. He did. The voice actor is the same for Raphael and Nightmare. Charles Klausmeier.
Oh. Well, there we go.
This is IMDb. So, yeah, I think what happened was there was supposed to be...
Yeah, they were supposed to do more with that, and then they
like,
just
between,
didn't.
Like, they were supposed to do more with Nightmare and with Viola and Zvi, because clearly Nightmare, or rather, Graf Dumas, knows about Zvi, but...
Okay, hold up.
Did they release more information at some point that we didn't know?
In the art book.
Ah.
All right, hang on. I'll read this, because this is the entry for Soul Calibur V regarding Raphael. I'll skip through some of this stuff. This is just fluff. Okay. Okay. He awoke with a start to find himself in a dark dungeon cell, thick with grime and the stench of death. He had no memory of how he had gotten there, but that wasn't important. He had to find Amy. When Raphael burst out of the prison, everything outside looked different than he remembered. But no matter. This world was but a fleeting dream, destined to be transformed into a new and better place, a world twisted to the needs of he and his beloved. Don't worry, Amy, I'll be with you soon. A force of madness was loose upon the world, a man who would stop at nothing to find his beloved. The art book confirms that Raphael died after the events of Soul Calibur 4, and that his body was used to make the reincarnation of the Azure Knight Nightmare, but Soul Edge had to rewrite some of Raphael's memories due to his strong willpower. So I called it. He did have willpower enough to kind of cause problems for Soul Edge. Nightmare, as Graf Dumas, had some of Raphael's personality and his cunning strategies, which causes Nightmare to try and take over the world rather than destroy everything on sight. To this end, he uses an army of Malfested and exploits politics to his advantages. It's unknown how Raphael appears in the story, but it implied that after he was freed from Soul Edge's influence, he regained his body and discarded the Azure Knight armor to look for Amy.
So when Pyrrha ends up with Soul Edge, it removes the Soul Edge control from Raphael's body.
Because that makes it sound
Wait,
like
Wait, that
Raphael...
means he is dead.
Yeah, he's like, actually
the
dead.
Raphael that's wandering around in this one is a vampire. I'm telling you, vampire. He is actually undead.
And this implies that even after the memory rewrite, he has strong enough will to just set it aside and go look for Amy instead. Like, Raphael has titanic willpower.
Yeah.
Holy shit!
Like, titanic enough willpower to change Nightmare and Soul Edge's MO.
Yeah!
Like, even rewritten.
That is nuts! I had no idea!
In the freaking art book, it gives us more story than the game itself.
The art book is where they tell us that Leisha is Shanghua's daughter and not of Kilik.
Yeah.
Like, that's where they gave that detail.
I'm so salty. Like, actually, I am so super salty.
Clarification there. They actually released that information on a Facebook post.
Yeah, I know.
Promoting the release of the art book.
I'm super salty.
That is intense.
I am super salty because that should have been in the game.
It really should. That would have made for a cooler story than the story we got.
Yeah, so that was going to be the plan, I think, for the story, and that's why Zvi and Viola are here.
Yeah, they just didn't get a chance.
They just never actually got to that point.
They were told, the deadline's tomorrow. We've only done a fourth of the story. Release it.
But we haven't even animated the fourth of the story we've done.
Put the frickin' sketches in.
But part of the sketches don't cover, because we couldn't draw them the way we... But we need that to be animated. There's no time. Release it anyway. But he falls off the cliff.
Some dev at Namco's.
It doesn't matter. They'll understand.
They'll get the point. Some dev is just sitting around like, man, I hope people will like our game. That'll be cool. It released yesterday.
What?
But we weren't even halfway done.
I really look forward to writing the last act.
Yeah, it was out a week ago.
I'm sorry?
What? Yeah, so the story was meant... So there were essentially two stories that were going to be told here.
Yeah.
There was the Zvi, Viola, and Raphael story.
I wonder, can I actually, like, play one of the other chapters, or do I have to, like...
And then there's... Nope.
Our previous to next episode, yeah.
And then,
Troclus, Klausenberg.
It's further than that. Yeah, there we go.
There we go.
And then, so. Oh, yeah, that's okay. After.
Yeah, alright.
So that's it.
Let me try playing this episode real quick.
Yeah, so. I think there was two stories. There was the Pyrrha, Tyrrha, and Troclus. And then there was this.
Yeah, so for anyone in archive land, this is the cutscene that we were just watching on YouTube.
You know of him, werewolf.
Yeah, he straight up calls him a werewolf.
That man stands in the way of ridding the world of the Malfested. Get rid of him.
And a
consistent accent.
Something to do with her? You just need to kill those I say to kill.
And then some, like, Japanese accent?
I've done everything you've asked. Yet you have made no effort to search for my sister. It seems you are unable to obey my orders. I've had enough. Leave my sight at once and never...
And that's where the Raphael voice
creeps
in.
Leave my sight at once.
Yeah.
Has no business making demands.
And this is so storyboard. It even has the marker.
Are you?
You are nothing more than a dog. I couldn't care less about what happened to a pathetic dog's family.
The accent is so all over the place.
It is.
So you've lied to me all this time.
Seriously, where do I know his voice actor?
Wait, you coward!
Rower.
Uh, Okay, so Grendel says, instead we have two whiny siblings angsting over two melodramatic swords between sexual tension. Man, this guy must be from the same place as Dukas.
Speaking of sexual tension. Also, Voldo was not the one in that storyboard. It was like some were-rat monsters in the storyboard. And now suddenly it's Voldo.
I thought it looked like Voldo.
Did it?
Yeah. I thought I saw Voldo in the foreground.
I didn't
or
know.
The background, rather.
Maybe I just misread the sketch. I don't know.
But yeah, like, I mean, I actually kind of like Patroclus and Pyrrha because they just had the crappiest of lives.
I mean, they're decently conceived characters. I just don't think they're really main character material.
Oh, they're not? I would never say they were. I mean, they're whiny, but I understand why they're whiny, so it doesn't bother me any that they're whiny, because I would be whiny in their place.
Oh, that whole, I am a holy warrior! It's a little like,
are
you now?
That part is, well, that's what he's been essentially told this whole time, so. That part's cringy, but Pyrrha doesn't actually bother me any, because she's whiny, but she's also been ridiculously manipulated the whole time, like... It's a miracle she's not just an evil psychopath already.
Sup? Throw him face first into a wall. The battle has finished. Damn it. He's gotten away. Oh, he did? Damn it, I wanted to fight him.
We don't get to.
Damn. Do we not? I could have sworn there was a fight against him at some point.
We don't get to fight Dumas until he's Nightmare.
Damn it! Yeah.
Yeah, you never get to fight him until he's Nightmare, and then his voice is all Nightmare-y. Yuri Lowenthal voices Patroclus. You know, Sasuke. Apparently he was in Code Geass as well.
Okay. It's the Sasuke thing that I'm hearing. I'm looking for any mention of Graf Dumas in here. Yeah, so now this is referring to him as Nightmare.
Mm-hmm. Because he's gotten his hands on the sword itself, not just partial.
And then the gate to Astral Chaos appeared. And then, kill the wielder of Soul Edge. Huh.
Yep.
Interesting.
Yeah, so I think there was meant to be two stories. There was meant to be the Pyrrha, Patroclus, and Tira.
Mm-hmm.
Version of the story, and then there was meant to be the Nightmare / Raphael, Viola, and Zvi part of the story.
Considering Tira's attachment to Soul Edge,
mm-hmm.
and therefore to a certain extent to Nightmare, one would think that we'd have seen more interaction with her.
She doesn't have anything to do with Dumas.
No, she doesn't.
She steals Soul Edge from the Nightmare and gives it to Pyrrha because she thinks Pyrrha is the true host of Soul Edge.
Man, I just wish we'd seen more of the conflict in another scene involving Tira and apparently Raphael. They could have done something with that.
Well, there's a lot that I think they were gonna do and just didn't.
Yeah.
Whether that got scrapped story-wise and we're just seeing what's left. Because maybe they did plan on doing it and then decided, that's too complicated. So, well, we've already modeled the characters and their fighting styles. Just keep them in. They'll just be, mercenaries.
Yeah.
It could be that that's what ended up happening since they don't go into any of that.
Mm-hmm.
We never even see Tira and, I think, Graf Dumas in the same scene ever.
I don't remember if we do.
I don't remember that. Grendel says, and I don't think you fight Nightmare until Zvi. You don't. It's Zvi versus Nightmare. Grail says, which is an awful name, by the way. Nightmare may be gender ambiguous, but Zvi is straight up Shonen Jump crap.
It really is. Well, especially with all the dots.
Well, that's because it's clearly short for something.
Yeah.
Not that we know what.
And Amy's not in this game. Damn.
No, it's just Viola.
Because I was going to compare their faces. Because I'm convinced that Viola is Amy under a different guise. I don't know if she knows she's Amy.
No, because she has no memories.
Yeah.
It said so in one of her bio things.
And I don't know why her hair turned shock white. Still, though, I am...
I'm betting it's whatever, like, whenever Raphael died and whatever happened to Amy after that.
Yeah. Maybe, like, the stress of it caused her to dissociate mentally.
Or there was some magic-y something. Because clearly she's a mage.
Oh, yeah.
She has magic.
She has more magic now than she ever did.
So I'm betting something to do with the magic that caused Raphael to become a semi, like, a semi-host of Soul Edge, except not entirely, because he doesn't have Soul Edge the sword yet, while he's Graf Dumas.
Oh, that's Amy.
That's Amy. That's just an older Amy.
Yeah, that is 100% Amy.
Complete with the eyes.
Yeah. And the nose shape.
Yeah,
and
that's
the curls.
That's the Amy and Raphael vampire eyes.
Yeah.
I always knew it was going to be Amy. Like, I had that thought from the... Who is Vi, though?
I also haven't checked out many of these customizable alts. Yeah. I just saw this one. I don't think I've ever looked at this. Dang, that's really cool.
Yeah. I looked at that one. I tried to recolor it, I think, to make it cooler, right. But it was... Because I tried to get rid of the purple, I think.
That's really cool. Wait a minute, hold up. Does she have a straight-up Naruto-style headband, complete with a metal plate on the forehead?
Yeah, because that's a piece of the other clothing you can do.
Can I not, like, move the camera up?
You can if you go...
I can't
to
go
colors.
To... Can I... Oh, yeah, there we go. No, oh, no, that's
not
a circlet. She just has a really shiny forehead that I mistook for a plate of metal.
Yeah.
Okay.
Grandel says, I wish they had a scene together, even just a throwaway line of dialogue.
Yeah.
Yep. And I like the 2P nightmare as well. Nightmare a lot.
Yeah.
I want to know who Zvi is.
Mm-hmm.
Because he's connected to Viola and Raphael somehow.
Yeah.
Because Graf Dumas' version of Raphael knows him by name.
Yeah, doesn't like him, so they have a history, apparently.
Yeah, and Zvi somehow comes across Viola, and they start traveling together.
Yeah. Also, what occurs to me, zoomed out, his face looks a lot like Bruce Lee. Like,
I think part of it is the hair.
It's the hair, it's the cheekbones, though, too.
Yeah.
Like, whoa, that looks like a young Mr. Lee.
But you know whose lips he has?
Kind of Raphael-ish.
He has Raphael's lips without the blue.
Yeah,
like, if you turned those bluish...
Yeah. Huh.
He just doesn't have the...
And it would
fit a little. Does he have the jaw of Raphael?
It's close. I mean, they do tend to make a lot of the male faces in this series look similar.
Even the female faces, if we're honest.
Like, thematically, it would fit to involve the story of the vampire with that of the werewolf.
Yeah.
Hmm. Interesting.
But why is he a werewolf, and what the heck kind of werewolf is that, and why does he have a number that's, like, not actually a number for a name, and why is his werewolf 1 and he's 2?
I don't know. That's...
Like...
That's a thinky thunkle right there.
Can we go look at Raphael's face again?
Go full vampire Raphael. He's got a little bit squarer a jaw than Zvi does.
Yeah. It's really... He has the same eyebrow line, though.
Sort of.
Complete with the furrow.
Well, yeah. I mean, his are a little lower.
Yeah.
The lines of the mouth, though, are very similar.
Yeah.
The
sharp cheekbones.
I'm willing to attribute that
to their...
just common aesthetics.
Yeah.
You know, weirdly, I kind of like his little, like, dangly bat chain.
Yeah. But yeah, I think what we're seeing is either a cut content because of time constraints, or they decided to not go that way because they thought it was too convoluted.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they've done complicated stories in the past.
This is the era of 5 after 4. Let's be honest. We are past the complicated storyline. Like, they might have decided that it was too much in one story and cut it. But because they'd already done, like, the storyboards, they'd already modeled, you know, the characters, they kept them in.
I forgot Hilda's alt was a full-on, like musketeer getup.
Mm-hmm. Colonel says, Zwei totally has Maxi eyebrows. Love child of Raphael and Maxi confirmed.
Hang on.
He does. The Zwei has, like, 3.
Yeah.
Yeah, his eyebrows are... They split at the end. They don't puff up as it goes. My goodness. You dye your hair, don't you, sir?
Well, I mean, we know he does, because his alt is blonde. Ryukyu Regent? Really? Okay.
Good boy. Can we look at Voldo? Can we actually get a good look at what Voldo looks like?
I don't know. Let's see.
Like the free.
Ooh, I forgot about that. Let's see here. Whoa. Dang.
We can.
That's about as exposed as we've ever seen him. Huh.
Interesting.
He looks like that judge guy on... American Idol. What's his face? Shit, I don't remember.
Howie Mandel?
Yeah, there we go.
It's only because he's bald.
Yeah.
Like, the rest of his face doesn't look anything like Howie Mandel.
I don't know, the lines of it do kind of remind me of him.
Howie, cheekbones, maybe.
You've had nicer days, man.
Girl says that's actually a hairpiece. His hairline has been receding since 2. Wait, really? Can we see his alt, Maxi's alt?
Is that canon? Is that, like, actually true?
I don't know. I Maxi?
Hang on.
Is his hairline any different? Or is he just wearing different hair pieces? Can we get... It's the same hair.
Yeah.
I can't tell.
I can't change it.
It doesn't really look like a hair piece, though.
Nah. Because you can see the roots.
He might have done some magic Rogaine.
Got some alchemical hair implants.
Mm-hmm.
That's how Ivy gets her side money.
I do want to know who Patroclus and Pyrrha's parents were.
Yeah.
Does Patroclus look like anybody, facial-wise? Because Pyrrha clearly looks like Sophia.
Yeah, oh yeah.
And actually, no, she looks more like Cassandra.
Yeah. Let's see.
But maybe the male face will give us...
Not really. I'm not really seeing any resemblance anyway. Which way? Get rid of that stupid hair! You're not in a... friggin' 90s band.
Give him the Raphael / Squall hair.
Actually, I think that's the Keeluk hair. Where's the... There we go. There's the Squall hair. Yeah, there we go. Just give him a scar across his nose and there's Squall. Man, that really changes the lines of his
Gendel
face.
Says, I got one bit of lore right now. You'll believe anything I say. Mwahahaha. Sophia and her husband that appears briefly in Soul Calibur 3. Her husband actually appears in SC3?
They did a lot of side character appearances using custom character assets, so it wouldn't surprise me. Also, it occurs to me, with this hair, he looks like Leon Kennedy.
Oh my god!
Like, he really does look like a young Leon S. Kennedy.
Oh, that's funny. Ooh, question. Can we do that with the Soul Cow?
You mean with...
I want to see her face.
Good question. I do like her full armor version.
Yeah.
Let's see.
We probably can't, but... We can't go.
What? That face!
That's not...
That...
That doesn't match what's under the...
Well, we never see under the visor, that's the thing.
I know, but, like, the mouth shape doesn't match under the visor, what we do see. At least not that I...
I don't know, something about those eyes.
She doesn't look like
Sophia
to me.
She is yandere AF. Like, whoa.
Well, she is.
I mean, yeah.
I mean, she doesn't really look like... She looks like baby Sophia.
She does.
She doesn't look like adult Sophia.
She really doesn't. She does kind of look like that chick that would slit your throat with a pair of rusty scissors in your sleep, though.
Gretel says it's Sophia. I mean... Is that face Sophia's face? Am I just remembering her looking more mature than she did?
I don't remember her looking that young. Hang on, let me...
Let's look at her actual.
Yeah, let me look at full war god mode here.
And I know she's modeled after Sophia. That's pretty clear.
Yeah, I think we don't see her mouth with the visor, though. That's
the other...
Thing.
I thought the blue one we could.
Maybe, because it's semi-transparent. I always thought this design, too, was sort of a callback to, like, Valkyrie profile.
Yeah. It needs different colors, though.
It does.
But yeah, like, try original, because it's kind of see-through. Let's see. Or at least it is in the art. Whether it is in practice, I don't know.
I don't remember getting a clear look at it. Yeah, I mean, like, you can kind of see through it.
Oh, it is. It is the same face.
Yeah, it is.
And I know she's modeled after Sophia. It's just...
I don't think it's modeled very well.
I don't think that face matches what I remember of the... actual Sophia. I know it's supposed to look like her because Patroclus thinks it's his mom.
Yeah, exactly.
For a while.
I mean, the face morphs of the characters change a little from game to game. So.
And of course, he's never seen his mom.
Yeah.
He's just heard, I think, vague descriptions. Mm-hmm. So.
I wonder. In free customize, can I see Keelix's face again?
No.
I can! Dude, I didn't know that.
Complete with Scar.
And he still looks intense as ever.
Why did they have to screw you over?
I don't know, man. Why'd you have to go and friggin' train in the mountains and go full Vajra mode? You could've hung out with Shanghua and had a kid. You know.
Or she could've come to the mountain with you, you know. And you could've still had a kid.
It's weird the delay when I move the camera and their eyes follow. It's off like a quarter of a second.
It's really disturbing.
It just sort of
Please
slides
stop.
Over.
Please stop.
Put on him. I'm curious. Can I, like, remake old Keelix? No.
They probably don't have old Keelix clothes.
No. Santa Keelix.
Santa Keelix?
Santa Keelix coming to town.
No.
Nah, dude. You don't really rock the modern trench.
No, it doesn't work. It
not
doesn't
so,
work.
Not so much.
It's not working. Huh. Poor Pura.
Yeah, and Tira's face morph has changed dramatically from
I
game
miss
to game.
Her old self.
I do too. God, what game? I think it was
three.
Four.
No,
it
was.
Or was it three?
Three was our favorite. Yeah. Four was squeaky.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Four was the one
they
where they changed
her
actress,
voice.
And she was annoying!
I hated her. Hated. Full hate. Wait, what can we do? What can we see?
Yoshimitsu.
Just out of curiosity, what does it let us see?
Namu, namu, namu.
Whoa.
Holy crap, that's awesome.
Is that what's under all that?
Whoa. Like, I knew he had the wooden robo arm. Those wraps, though, like that.
And, like,
looks
there looks like blood or tears on one eye.
Yeah.
Wow.
Dang.
That's cool. Grendel says you get classic Astaroth and free customize.
Really? Let me see. Man,
Grindel, you know stuff about this game that I don't. Whoa, that is old Astaroth! Like, old Astaroth. Whoa.
We haven't done much customizations with the...
Yeah, the canon characters.
The canon characters, because our favorite... Because we... The story was so lame. Yeah. And so our favorite part...
was making our own.
Was making the own characters. So we haven't... Well, let's look at all the others.
Yeah.
Who else is out there? Let's see.
Hold on. What all is going on with Shiva? Not much.
What about Siegfried? What happens if you go free mode with him?
I don't know. Because I know his alt is just the tunic.
What other secrets? Nothing.
Not much.
Underwear.
Just,
and his face looks so weird.
Yeah, his has changed so much from game to game.
Like, when he first showed up on screen, I'm like, that's not Siegfried.
Yeah.
Like,
now he's friggin' Nordic Carl Urban.
Yeah. Like, it was very strange to me. What does free edit of Pyrrha allow? Pyrrha Omega.
I wonder if it shows just how far up the claw arm goes.
Yeah.
She just doesn't have it, apparently. I guess that's just an affectation of her armor.
She All has right. the malfested eyes, though.
Yeah, she's got that and a little shield thing in her hair. Okay.
That's because that's her hair.
Yeah.
Well, we can try changing it and see if the shield thing stays.
Yeah, I wonder.
Nope, that's her hair.
Hmm.
She looks so miserable and sad.
Mm-hmm.
She's like, hostage eyes, please save me.
God, when you zoom out, too, it's like, please don't leave.
I'm scared. I don't want to be alone.
That's intense. Let's see. I know Algol's ult looks awesome.
Mm-hmm. What's free?
I don't know.
Algol.
I did make one edit of Algol that I really liked. What else can we do with him?
Whoa, we get all the tats.
Yeah, all his tattoos are there.
And his long nails that need to be cut. I'm sorry, buddy.
You know who his face reminds me of?
You know, his eyebrows look like Svi's. Or I guess Svi's eyebrows look kind of like his.
With the tufty. I mean, yeah, they're each fuzzy. They're not really the same lines, though. You know what his face really reminds me of, though? Like, obviously, change the color of the hair and lose the, like, weird dreads. He reminds me of Angeal.
Yeah?
Like, a lot.
Yeah, he does.
Huh.
He does have kind of the Angeal face. The rest of him, not so much.
No. For anyone curious, I did actually make an Angeal in this game. Where do you go? Somewhere around here.
There he is.
There he is. Yeah, I'll show off a little.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I think I did all right, considering the pieces available to me.
Mm-hmm. Is there any of the other characters I want to see in free mode?
I don't know. This is one of the ones I'm most proud of.
Mm-hmm.
I think Genesis turned out really well.
I think so, too.
Let's see.
What about Tira free?
I don't think I've ever looked at her alt. Hang on.
Grendel says, I have returned. Laptop spontaneously died right after I said the Astaroth thing.
It's all good.
Wow. What's with the weird hair, Tufty?
I hate it.
I hate everything about it.
Yeah. Not really my speed.
I think it's trying to go for Dark Valkyrie style.
I kind of thought they were going a little like burlesque with it.
Maybe.
Oh no.
I'm not sure. I just know that I hate it.
Okay, so it just starts out that way.
Oh.
Okay.
And you keep the makeup. I was wondering if we saw her without her super made-up face. You know, she has the same eyes as Raphael and
well, yeah, it's the,
Viola.
Like, certain degree of malfestation, I think they call it.
Hmm. Or maybe it's because they're not fully living properly anymore, because they are not normal people.
I'm sure they're not. I do like her little, like,
her little
raven skull
raven
things.
Raven skull things in the end of her braids.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder how much it changes her face to change her hair, though, because that really makes a difference on some characters.
Randall says, I get that one is supposed to be her moody costume and one her manic costume, but really the TP for Tira is awful. Is that really?
Was that the idea?
Like, are we going full Shivering Isles?
Yeah, that's what I was just thinking.
Okay, what about, what is, can we actually edit Etsu?
I don't think so.
No, there's
no
only
free
the two.
Edit.
What is Ivy's alt in this one?
Oh, it's the fursuit. I had purged the fursuit from memory. Looks like a friggin' Lady Gaga costume.
Not one of the good ones.
Like, it's...
Not one of the good ones. Oh, it's worse up close. Oh, it's shiny and furry. And she looks miserable, too. Look at that fit. That...
Why did you dress me in this? And that ridiculous snake choker, too.
How
does
she
tail.
Get that on?
If she leans her head to the left, that tail's gonna pierce her jugular.
Also, how does that come... How do you get it on and off? Is there a catch in the back?
I mean, maybe it's not as solid as it looks.
Oh,
maybe
it's
actually...
solid. You can't tell me that's not just pure gold.
I don't know. Because if that's pure gold, again, if she leans her head to the left, that tail tip will pierce into her neck!
It doesn't bend with her breathing, though.
No, it doesn't.
It's very rigid.
It's very stiff. Ugh. Oh, I hate it. Oh, I hate it. I hate it so much.
What's the free edit for her?
Probably just...
Just... No,
like,
clothes.
Yeah, her in underclothes, I would imagine. Yeah, sounds normal. That's about what I thought.
I am officially not okay. Ooh, can we see all of Mitsurugi's scars on Free Edit?
Maybe. I like that you can make, essentially, Soul Cal 2 Mitsurugi through his alt in this game. Yeah.
Grendel says that's what they did since her first appearance, full Shivering Isles.
Huh. I didn't realize that.
Your beard doesn't match your hair, sir.
No, it doesn't. His normal hair is, like, really gray. That's weird.
That's because it matches his eyebrows.
Also, I'm going to pop quiz you. Do you remember what that circular scar is from? Nah.
Bullet?
Yeah. From?
Cervantes?
No. It was from a Tanegashima rifle when those were gaining prominence in Japan. And he got shot and it checked his ego.
Yeah.
And he was like, because I must prove myself stronger than these upstart weapons.
Okay.
So...
I knew it was a gunshot wound, but I was like, it's gotta be from one of the other characters, right?
To my knowledge, it's not. It's just some
soldier.
Oh,
his legs. What are... Oh, them. Oh.
He's got, like, that zero body fat.
Oh, it's so...
Physique.
It's gross.
Yeah, it's not healthy. That's, like, the perfectly muscled sort of thing where...
It's gross. Oh, it looks gross. Oh. Okay, hang on. Grendel says, that's a real Dark Souls beard there.
Yeah, it really is.
So, I guess... So they have been going full Shivering Isles with Tira. I don't see it that they both look...
Yeah.
Like, I couldn't tell you which one's supposed to be Mania and which one's not.
I don't know.
Cover up the gross legs, please.
Thank you. Can I make, like, Samurai Lord Mitsurugi or something?
No, probably not. Because his hair clips with everything. Thank you for getting rid of the ugh. Abs.
You okay there?
Yeah, I'm good. Can we change his beard? Can he not have a beard that doesn't match any of the rest of his? No. Oh, color. Maybe we can change the color. Maybe we can make him gray. We can change his hair. I bet if we change the color, I bet if we go to color, we might be able to change it.
There we go.
He doesn't even look like the same person anymore.
He doesn't. He really doesn't.
His face suddenly looks totally different without his shaggy hair.
Oh, can I put a sakkot on him? I know that doesn't really match the coat thing still.
So, her gallery.
Yeah, there we go. Or a kimoso. I always thought those were ridiculous.
I freaking hate wikis. There we go. Here's the gallery. I mean, I knew they were going for, like, the dark gestury look.
Well, that much was obvious. I didn't think they were going for the manic and mania thing.
I mean, obviously she's manic.
Yeah, oh yeah. Like, I see it now that it's pointed out. I just didn't know that's what they were going
for. No. I mean, I get it. Like, I do see it. It's just, I couldn't tell you in her outfits in this game which one's supposed to be mania and which one's not.
He's holding that stick up, just clenching his ass around it. Like, the angle
that
of that.
Hurts. Please stop. Please make it go away. Thank you. I'm not sure I like the hat with everything else.
I'm seeing how far I can take it. And, not very far, it turns out. Here we go. And,
That's about it
there. That's what sedge shade is what they call that. It's a sakkot. Come on, game. Let's see. All right, yeah. Oh, it clips into his hair.
It clips in everybody's hair, including the females. Like, those don't not clip with basically anything but, like, the buzz.
Yeah. Well, darn.
Grendel says, purple is always moody, yellow is always manic. She's always batshit, though.
Oh, yeah. Totally.
Except for the times where she's purple and yellow.
There we go. Well, yeah, I mean, I haven't customized the colors. I'm not going to keep this.
I think his beard looks fake in general.
Like, it's just stuck onto his face. Let's see.
What about Cervantes?
Yeah, that's what I was just thinking. Whoa, I forgot that was his ult in this one. Full plate armor.
Suddenly he looks entirely different, too.
Yeah, without the hat, he looks different. He looks like an angry motorcycle gang leader.
You riding in our territory? I'm gonna have to chain whip you with my cracker.
Oh, the chest hair looks so gross and fake.
Like, it's just dryer lint that's glued to his chest.
That they glued to him.
Alright. I'm done messing around in that. So I think I'm gonna give this.
Are we not gonna make our characters?
Not right now. We may mess around with that another time. Whew. I think for now, I'm gonna give this one more arcade run and then call it an evening. We can at least end on some action.
Yeah, Grendel says he borrowed some of Maxie's eyebrow hair and glued it onto his neck. He's never been able to grow a full beard, and all the other samurai laughed at him. So that's the story behind.
I think I'm gonna wrap this on my custom Algol, because I freaking love how he came out. Leja, I will destroy you. Because you shouldn't exist! You are the product.
The shipper in me is upset.
You're the product of mediocrity and settling. Goddamn right.
I forgot. every time she comes on screen, I remember how much I hate her. Like, I remember it anew. Also, is Owl here again?
I don't remember, because, like, his story was kind of done and over with in 4.
Yeah. Like, he was at peace or something, depending on who won.
He's just sort of here again now.
Mm-hmm. No, so Owl is actually pretty cool. Shame he's the product of SC4. He was the one good thing about SC4.
Exactly.
Like, except he apparently made, like, Soul Calibur and Soul Edge.
Yeah, he's the forger of them. And, like, his soul, or rather, his son's soul was consumed, and, like, that's why he made an opposition sword, etc.
He was forced to kill his own son and hated it. And then hated himself.
Algo's story is another one, sort of like Ivy. It's really dark. I'm just sad that we only got such a small glimpse of it, because 4 was... Let's call it an anemic story.
It's not as bad as this one.
Yeah, it is. It's worse. It's way worse.
That's true.
Because it didn't have a story mode.
That's true. I hate the story mode in this one so much, it's almost better than it did. Grendel says, well, he made Soul Edge, and he just killed so many people with it, it became sentient and hilariously evil.
Yep.
Because he was a war king. He was a conqueror king.
Oh, yeah. Of a civilization that apparently history doesn't even remember. Or maybe he's, like...
I also like the fact that,
He can just summon a throne.
Summon the throne.
I love that.
And he has, like, a weird, like, gun arm. I'm like...
Yeah.
What the heck, man? I have an energy cannon.
Because I like Mega Man. Judge me. Anyway, like, maybe he's, like, Akkadian or something. Some ancient civilization that most people don't even know anything about.
Yeah.
I could see that. Maybe Sumerian. Because clearly this story takes a lot of liberty with history and whatnot. And while I like Algol, I'm not super great with him, so I'm just kind of figuring it out as I go. Oh, stop! I hate that move so much. I'm even like looking at it. I'm just gonna impale you on my ribs for a second. Hang on. I forgot how ridiculous some of those attacks are.
Thwunk!
It's why you can't make an Algol-style character, I think.
Yeah, I don't think you can. You can only customize him.
Because it's so much tied to his...
To his character model.
Yeah. I have no idea how to say that, but Grendel says, I'm pretty sure he's entirely inspired by the... Ozymandias poem?
Oh. Is he supposedly Ozymandias? Because that's a connection I hadn't made. That's a cool idea. The battle rages on. Stand up and show your strength. Battle three. Fight.
There's so much of this game that makes no sense.
Oh, there is. Most of this game makes no sense.
Mm-hmm. Grendel says, for a second there, I just saw Shiba's tail and thought he was wearing one of those furry tails.
I mean, he kind of is.
He sort of...
Like, it's not, an actual tiger skin.
It's an actual tiger skin, which...
Cooler than what most people just get on Amazon. Still, though, like... I hate Shiba and everything about her.
You don't stand a chance. I hate you. I hate you so much.
The coolest thing about her is her feathered lamellar armor. Because styling lamellar as feathers looks cool.
Yeah.
It's her only redeeming quality in my eyes. Stomp. Realized and then thought about the implications of, hang on, that move right there, hang on, I'll do it again, watch, like, the character movement when I do that. Can you imagine what the animation director in the mocap room
told
the actor doing that move? Because he's just thrusting his crotch at the enemy. Like, yeah. This is for a fighting game, right?
Yeah.
You're not going to reuse these animations for something else? Because my contract has very strict stipulations. Like, once again, I can't ask this enough. You did say this is for a fighting game.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just saying, this doesn't seem very fighty.
Chair.
Forgot about the chair teleports. Yeah, let me just chair-aport onto your head. Wonk. Oh, crap, how do I do the chair? I don't remember now. I had it, and then I lost it.
I forgot the really shiny necklace. Yeah. Like, overworked necklace you gave him. Randall says, is Soul Calibur 6 supposed to be a reboot? Says new timeline in a tab on the wiki.
We don't know.
It could be a reboot. It might be time travel shenanigans. We don't know.
Yeah, I do know that it's at least set in an earlier period.
Yeah.
Because clearly, like, that's young Yoshimitsu, not Yoshimitsu, Mitsurugi, Sophitia is in it again.
Uh-huh.
So, it's set earlier, I just don't know necessarily why, from a storytelling perspective. Whether it is a reboot, or whether it's Chronomancy, or whatever. I almost hope it's a reboot, and that they start taking the story more seriously, or, on the other side of the coin, just ditch the story entirely. Because if they're not going to do anything...
Like, if they're not going to make it interesting and actually do something that's worthy of it, then just make it a fighting game.
Exactly. Just set it aside. Go full Street Fighter with it. Don't even worry about story. Just make a good fighting game. And
with lots of character customization, because everybody loves that.
Exactly. Just, like, don't even waste development time on a story that you're not going to take seriously as a developer anyway. That's my take.
But if they do decide that they're going to go full story mode on it, then hopefully it's either a split timeline or a full reboot. I'm going to bet, because they're calling it Soul Calibur 6, that it's going to be a split timeline, not a reboot, or they would have just, like, I can't imagine they'd have put 6 as its title.
Yeah, if it was a reboot, that they would just call it Soul Calibur with no number.
Yeah, like they did with Tomb Raider, and just start over. Randall says, apparently Siegfried is Nightmare again.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so it's SC2 era.
Yeah.
Interesting.
I thought we saw Nightmare.
Yeah, I didn't remember if we did.
I remember seeing Nightmare, or at least I thought I did.
Don't make me chair you. Because I will chair!
Crush your spine. I love the chair.
Off my throne, Jester. The king sits there.
Nope. You're all about law versus chaos.
Mm-hmm.
Maxie, I'm so sorry. Just stop.
Why are you even here anymore?
Why are you here? Why are you here?
Why are you here when Zhonghua isn't? Just like the rest of them. Yeah, you are. I know I just went full child schoolyard. I know you are, but what am I? Shut up.
Why are you still here? And what happened to Songmina?
I don't know. She just sort of stopped appearing in games. And I don't know why. Because she was cool, and I was good with her, which is why I'm mostly salty.
And also, apparently, Talim just went back to her monastery or whatever.
Yeah. Yeah, that's one of the things that the comments on the SoulCal page are raving over, is everyone's just like, I'm not gonna get it if it doesn't have Talim. Like, man, people want their Talim.
Hate it. I hate it so bad. And I tried really hard to make a good-looking Talim. It's not easy.
Not really,
Grendel says, I swear to Christ, SC6 better be released on PC. It won't be.
I don't know. Maybe.
I don't know. Has Namco released recent games on PC?
I don't know. Like, a lot of fighting games are now getting PC releases, so they may follow that trend suit, even if they haven't yet.
Yeah, they might.
Whoa, how'd I do that?
I don't know.
Oh, uh-oh. Shit.
Uh-oh.
No! Shit, away I go.
Womp womp. They might do a PC release, but I don't know if they will.
Because
I'm not sure if they're gonna go the.
The thing is, Namco is one of those companies
that are going
is
still full Japanese.
They're still really regressive, so. God, I'm trying to figure out how to do the chair at will. That's my main goal here. I just want a throne drop on people at will. Something to do with triangle circle. There it is. Okay.
I love the fact that he just sits down. It's like, I'm bored.
It's just there. Thwunk!
Gerda says, well, with the latest Tekken, I hope the precedent has been set.
I hope so, yeah. Well, the latest Tekken, the latest Mortal Kombat, like, a lot of fighting games are now getting PC releases, so.
Yeah. I just don't know if Namco will follow suit.
I only hope so. Owie. That's a couple of ring outs in a row, Maxie. How dare you? Stop screwing around now. Now that
you
I
can't
know,
lose to Maxi.
Now that I know how to chariport.
Of all of them, you can't lose to Maxi. I will be very upset with you if you lose to Maxi.
I just have to stay away from the edge and don't want him to ring me out. Chair! Aw, he guarded against my chair. Ha ha! Sword wings! I'm going full Bahamut here. Not again. Not again. Screw you, Maxie. Chair. I could swear I actually, like, summoned it onto his head at one point, though. How did I do that?
Well, you slam it onto their back somehow.
Well, like, I know I can do that with his ults. It was a normal move, though.
Yeah, I don't know. Oh, Grendel says Tekken is Namco. Is it? Is Tekken Namco?
I don't remember. Well, yeah, I guess it would have to be, because they do... So yeah, I mean, if Tekken does.
If Tekken did, then yeah, I'm sure Soul Calibur 6 probably would be.
Yeah. Oh, God. We have a real problem here. Oh, no. Denied. Ha!
Thank you.
Heel drop!
I was about to tell you that you are not allowed to lose to him.
I was getting a little worried there for a second.
I mean, I couldn't use the traditional threat of you're sleeping on the couch tonight because you
I've
are.
Slept on the couch for the last 3 weeks.
But there was going to be some kind of I cannot believe that you died to that.
And not because I'm in trouble, because I know someone's going to make that assumption. No, it's because
it's
more
comfortable
angle for my jacked up muscles. I'm hoping actually in the next couple of days I can actually return to sleeping in our own damn room again.
I know. Because I know you miss your
I miss
bed.
Our mattress, man.
I know you miss the bed. I know.
And cuddling you is nice too, I guess.
It better be.
Ow. Kill it. Do you mind?
Spine. He minds. Clearly. Grandless, let's hope so, because I sold my PS4 after I got the PC. But Soul Calibur is my franchise bay.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
There.
I still can't believe you didn't know why it was spelled Calibur. Right.
I never made the connection!
I'm still... I thought it was obvious!
Yeah, for anyone that's confused here, when she was inputting the data for the meta stream stuff... When we
I just wanted to
streaming.
Make sure that everything was spelled right, like Soul Calibur was two words,
yeah, and,
that sort of thing.
And I made sure to tell her that
it's got a weird spelling for Calibur.
Yeah, they spell Calibur with a U instead of an E.
And I was like...
And she was like, yeah...
That's how it's spelled.
I'm like, no, it's not, because like the caliber of a firearm cartridge is spelled with an E, and that's
I'm like,
they're
talking about
that...
Excalibur.
Yeah, I had never made that connection. I don't know why. I
should have. Like the fancy super sword of Arthurian myth. Like, I'm pretty sure that's where the caliber part of Soul Calibur comes from.
I am certain you're correct. I had just never thought of that. I hear the word caliber without the X on the start of it. And my mind immediately jumps to, oh, gun terminology! Because caliber also means, like, you know, a gauge of something. So I thought it was just like, oh, the strength of a soul or something like that, yeah? The caliber of their souls is maximum.
No,
that's what I thought it was trying to get at. I never made the Excalibur connection.
Because it's all about the super swords.
I know that now! I'm allowed to have some dirt moments every now and again.
Oh, no.
I'm not going to win this. Oh, God.
You are allowed to lose to Keelik. I will allow that.
Because he's hard in this game.
He's not Maxi, so it's fine. Asgard says, I'm awake now. Asgard says, Soul Cal 7, Soul Edge is a shotgun.
The modern remake. The 50 cal machine gun of Soul Edge.
I would hate that.
So would I, actually.
Grendel says, actually, that sounds badass.
Like, as a gun guy, I don't want a gun Soul Edge.
They couldn't do it right.
No.
They could not and would not do it right.
It would end up goofy.
No modern Soul Cal, please.
Not that
like, the closest I want of that is the Zossalamel ending of...
Yeah, what, that ending
four,
is really
where
cool,
he's
yeah.
in the future and is, like...
Oh, God. What was that little hop? Hold on. Because I'm hovering. What do I need to hop for? How did I do that? Ah, this isn't the character to be fighting to try and experiment. I want to see his goofy little hop again.
Like, it would be interesting to have, like, a Soul Cal, Soul Edge, the gun, if I thought they would do it right.
I just don't
think they'd do it right. Like, I do think it would be cool if they could do it right, but I just don't see it.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Well, I mean, we've seen how they treat it in Tekken.
Yeah.
They don't know guns.
No, they really don't. Or a shotgun does, like, dinky damage, and yet a really hard punch does, like, five times that punch.
Grendel says, I'm technically correct. Cervantes will probably have a Soul Edge weapon variant.
That's true.
He's had that before.
Yeah, because he's got his, like, gunblade thing.
Yeah, so... And he has had a Soul Edge variant in a different game.
Well, once upon a time, he was the wielder.
So I'm sure... I think we've had the gun Soul Edge before.
Jeez, it's just a little, like, hilt pistol version, not, like, a rifle.
Yeah.
Like, I guess... If they went with, like, an old, like, maybe another Japanese character with, like, a Tanegashima rifle.
Yeah.
That, you know, suddenly shows up and Mitsurugi's like, you!
Yeah. That'd be funny. Like, I would actually find that very amusing.
If it was actually the guy that
shot Mitsurugi.
If it was
the one, yes. I would find that enormously amusing.
I actually would, too. Like, I would really get into that. Oh, man, what if they made it? Oh, God, what's his name? Oh, shit, this is gonna get me. Oh, God, what was his name? He was in Samurai Warriors, the guy with the rifles. I have to look this up on my phone. I have to. Shut up, Algo, I don't need your shit. Hang on.
You are cool, though.
Let's see here. My Warriors, rifle... Refile. Yeah, there we go. Magoichi Saika. If they made it Magoichi and faced him off against Mitsurugi, because they're from, I think, the same era, I would love that! I don't think it's ever going to happen, though.
No, probably not. Probably not. Also, Algol is cool.
He is.
I think that's why they put him in here. It's just because he's cool.
Further rule
of there's
cool.
No Zossalamel, though.
Is there not? Oh, yeah, that's right, because we were looking through, like, everyone.
Uh-huh. So I'm betting, because in 4, there was a Zossalamel.
Yeah.
Because in 3, it was Zossalamel, the bad guy. So in 4, the bad guy was Algol, so now in 5, Algol's in it, and it was Zossalamel. So maybe in 6, we'll have Soul Edge, or rather, Soul Calibur, like
I am a little
Elysium.
Confused about why... Inferno, to pronounce it the way the announcer always did ridiculously, isn't in 4 or 5. Because that was the spirit inside of Soul Edge in 2 and 3. And you even fight it as a disembodied flame monster during, I think, 2?
I don't know. I mean, maybe that's what's in Hap.
Or, like, maybe it died or was changed during the events at the end of, I think also 2, when they, like, plunge Soul Calibur into the eye of Soul Edge and they get all intertwined and everything. Yeah. Like, I don't know.
Grendel says, I wish they kept the legacy movesets like Zoslima for character creation.
Yes.
That would be cool. They didn't, though.
They didn't.
They didn't put any new character stuff that isn't from one of the base characters in.
Or, you know, like, allow the Talim moveset to get used for custom characters.
Songmina.
Songmina. Who else have they cut? Because I know they cut more than that.
Amy,
yeah. Amy Sorrell.
Though,
She used to have her own distinct style.
She did. She had a different style.
Yeah.
It was not Raphael's style. It was reminiscent of it, but it wasn't the same.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because I think she was using a style that was very similar in 4 to the custom Rapier user style in 3.
Yes. That's because in 3, when you played through the story mode that had her in it,
she was made
using that style. So the custom character rapier style became the
Amy style.
The Amy style.
Yeah.
But yeah, there's a lot of stuff that I wish.
So.
But isn't.
I'll just close this out saying I hope.
We're hoping for good things in
6. I hope they take their time, yeah.
Well, they have taken their time.
Definitely. It's just, they've taken their time in even starting to make one. I hope they take their time in the making of it.
Yeah, or that they just didn't announce it and have been working on it.
Yeah, either way. You know, just like, I want a more polished game
with
than
more to
4
it.
Or 5 was.
Yeah.
And either a good story...
Or no story.
Because if they're not going to go deep into it the way they used to, then just don't even...
Yeah, just don't worry
Just
about
give
it.
Us a great fighting game that's as good as you can possibly make it, and set all the story on the shelf.
Or go old school.
Yeah.
Do detailed story. Do maybe even the story that was apparently going to be part of this one, which clearly we didn't get that.
I mean, this is far enough along in the timeline.
I know,
though,
they're not going to.
If they're restarting the timeline.
If they're restarting it,
they're not
going
to get to this point.
No. But, like, just do, like, if you're going to put in new characters, actually do stuff with them. Let us know who the heck they even are.
Yeah.
And why they're involved in any of the conflict.
Yeah.
You know, even if it's just a bio on their character screen, that's better than what we got for this game.
Yeah.
So, please.
And don't release all the juicy story details in the art book this time.
Put it in the game itself.
God damn it.
Yeah.
So anyway.
Okay, let's see. Grendel says, at the very least, embedding SoulCal 6 will be mechanically fun.
I'm
tentatively hoping for the rest. I'm glad they realized everybody hated their new characters. I didn't. Actually, I did not hate the new characters. I hated what they did with them in the story, and that they didn't do enough to make us like them.
Excluding Leija and Shiva.
Yeah, no, they didn't do enough to make any of the new characters.
Yeah, that's fair.
Like, maybe I would have even warmed up to them if we'd gotten more than 2 scenes.
Yeah.
Like, they were throwaway characters that didn't really need to be in this. In what ended up in this story.
Yeah, they're just here because they needed to have a Chinese sword and a staff wielder.
Yeah, so, like, I don't mind Patroclus and Pyrrha, and I don't mind Viola and Zvi.
Yeah, we just want to see more of them.
They just didn't give us enough to really understand exactly what's going on here.
Yeah.
And I think that's where they went wrong, is that...
It.
Yeah, they didn't finish it. They just didn't give us enough about these characters. Like, we didn't, like, if... Going into the characters that I actually didn't like, the new ones, which was Shiva, Leisha, and Natsu, I think her name is.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe if they'd actually gone into their backstories, like, who they are, why they're doing the things they're doing, and actually gave them characterization, heaven forbid, Maybe they wouldn't have been so obnoxious, but all we got is the stupid little catchphrases in the middle of combat. Like, that's basically all we got for them. So, of course, we're going to hate them because they don't match the rest of the way everybody talks.
Yeah, they clash, their personalities are grating, and we don't know enough about them to appreciate why, so...
Yeah. So, I feel like it's not that everybody hated the new characters. Everybody hated the fact that the new characters replaced characters that they loved, first off.
Yeah. I'm going to say mostly that.
Yeah, that. I think that's really the problem, and that the new characters that they did use to replace them...
weren't nearly as charming?
Yeah, they didn't have the charm. They didn't go into any of the story that made the old characters as charming as they were.
Yeah.
And with the quote-unquote main characters of this story, the story felt unfinished.
Because it was.
Because it they're clearly was.
They're still using storyboards
and
the cutscenes. And
they're missing sections.
Entire illustrations just aren't there.
So I think that that's really the problem, is that they didn't finish it. They didn't give detail to the new characters to give us enough to love them at all.
Yeah.
So, I'll
at least say that I have liked the look of the footage I've seen.
Of the combat?
For the combat, the movesets,
mm-hmm.
and the smoothness of the animation for six, because I have seen several videos now about Mitsurugi, because he's my favorite character, so of course I watch those.
Mm.
I also watched the collab video that they did with the SoulCal 6 devs and the consultants from CD Projekt Red that were there to help them get Geralt right for his guest appearance.
And it seems like they really did very well with that. They did amazingly.
Yeah, they did a great job with animating Geralt right, because he is very...
he's not flashy at all.
Yeah, exactly. He's very energy conscious. He's practical in his moveset, from what I can see. The one thing that I thought was funny, though, and I can't tell if it was an intentional editing flair or if it was an accidental, like... subversion of what they were saying in the moment, because in that same video that they posted on the Soul Calibur Facebook page, one of the devs was saying that Geralt never makes any extraneous movement. He never wastes energy. He doesn't do anything flashy. And on screen, while he's saying that, is Geralt doing an unnecessary sword spin flourish right after having struck an opponent. And he doesn't do very many of those things. It's just in that moment,
in that
right as he's saying
moment,
it.
Yeah.
I'm like, could you have timed that any worse?
Mm-hmm. Gandalf says, I just want to annihilate everybody else's Nightmare. He's my fave. we'll have to see what they do with Nightmare's moveset. Hopefully he's not cheap
He
is in this game.
Yeah, I miss the days of when Nightmare was a skill cannon. Because he was slower yet really powerful with a few quick moves that you could use to cut off incoming attacks and set opponents up for the slower, heavier moves. In this game, like, especially at launch, because they've patched
for him. They did.
He was stupid fast, really powerful.
He was faster than Siegfried. Faster than some of the quote-unquote fast characters.
He was faster than Mitsurugi. Like, he gave Alpha Patroclus a run for his money in terms of speed, and it was stupid. It was mad OP. They've since patched him out. They've slowed him down.
He's still too fast, I'm going to say. He's still faster than Siegfried.
He's still too fast, I think, for the amount...
Because they didn't lessen the amount of damage he did when they sped him up for this game.
And he still does heavy damage. Yeah, some of his really fast moves also have unfairly... because I've even measured this out in training mode... an unfairly long range. Like, if you look at where
the
ends of his sword model is, it still actually connects with an enemy several inches out from that point.
So the hitbox is...
it's too generous.
In his favor. In his favor, yeah. So, and that's why he can just sort of combo you to death.
Exactly.
And there's not really much to be done about it.
Because he knocks you away.
And that used to be even worse in the launch version.
Yeah, once he got started on you at the launch version, there was no getting out of it.
No.
He just already won.
If he landed a hit, you were done.
Yeah. And like even as it stands right now, there
are
a lot of combos where...
pretty much like that.
Yeah, he knocks you away, and any other character would have just knocked you outside of their own reach, so you have time to keep up and recover. With him, you're still in his reach, and he can just air juggle you, and then pick you up off of the ground, and keep pummeling you after standing you up forcibly. So, he isn't as OP, he's still OP, though.
So I hope it goes back to fairer, but still, like, in the hands of somebody who knows the moveset and knows what they're doing, still really good.
Because he should play, like, a powerful character. I just miss the days when it took skill to communicate that.
Yeah. And I think AIs have come, like, the character AIs have come far enough that you can get that across in an AI, no problem.
Oh, totally.
Because
that's just conditional programming.
Yeah. So I hope they go that route instead of just the OP because he's supposed to be strong.
Yeah.
Like, just the Bull in a China Shop style. But we'll have to see. I'm hopeful for it because they are going back to a different time frame.
Mm-hmm.
You
know what I really hope?
Because
we are going to SC2 era.
Mm.
I really hope that they return to the SC2 Mitsurugi moveset.
Yeah.
Because that
is your favorite.
Was the greatest moveset they ever gave him. I was so mad when they changed it.
Grendel says he looks fast as fuck in the character showcase. And holy shit, he has a nightmare horse. Nightmare rides a nightmare.
Wait, he has a horse now?
That's probably an alt move.
That's cool.
Like trampling someone.
Yeah.
Alright. Well, if he is super fast, if they decide to go tone down the damage. Because
There are still ways to make that
And make
fair.
Sure that the hitbox doesn't unfairly boost him and not other characters.
Because I mean, he should have good range, just not more range than his weapon actually has.
Yeah. Grendel says it's a fucking unicorn too.
What?
It's a unicorn nightmare because he has the forehead spike. So there. Oh my gosh.
I sort of love that.
That's amazing.
Dark unicorn.
That's hilarious. Right. Oh, that's amazing. Okay, on the dark on the nightmare riding a nightmare unicorn front. I think that's a good time to call that.
That's a good place to close out. So, thank you guys for hanging out with us, because, man, we have covered some ground today. And I'm definitely going to have to come up with a clever title for this export.
Oh, man, I don't know what we're going to call this thing.
So y'all have a fantastic remainder to your day. And thank y'all kindly for watching. Since I do need to start plugging us a little more. So, if you've enjoyed this stream, consider checking out our Patreon to help us keep the show alive, because I take self-promotion seriously.
Anyway, we would appreciate any help you're willing to give.
Every little cent helps, seriously. Like, the folks that message me, like, I'm sorry, I can only do $1. Like, dude.
That's enough.
$1 is great, because it's more than zeros.
Yep.
So anyway, cheers to all of you guys. Hope you all have had fun. I know I actually have. This is really, like, improved my already good mood today. So
I'm glad to hear that.
So thank you guys. Anyway, I'm Kizmark here at Less Level Press.
I'm Violeta.
And as always, we wish you all good gaming
and Godspeed. Bye.